Hello, 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 everybody. How's it going? Happy, happy Sunday. Happy, happy Monday. I hope everyone's doing well. And it's nice to see you tonight. We are getting back into some Zelda today. We're going to be resuming the good old Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. For those of you who haven't seen, we started this game up last weekend. I have played the original one on the Wii, but with the remake coming out on the Switch and, you know, me not having played it yet, I wanted to go ahead and do it here, and it's been really fun so far. I think where we left off, if I'm remembering correctly, is right at the start of the second dungeon, the Earth Temple. So I'm pretty excited to hop back in, do some of that for a bit, and then continue from there. But I do hope that you're all doing well. And it is good to be here. It's good to see you tonight. And so thank you for popping in.
How goes everything?
Royal Raceway, I think. This is a Mario Kart 64 theme for sure. Hey, Sigma, it's good to see you. Welcome in, happy 7 months. I'm doing well. I'm doing very well. I'm a little tired because I had a long weekend, but it was a fun one. I'll tell you all about it if you'd like. But before I get too ahead of myself, I suppose, welcome on in Dom, who frankly would have had the first tonight, but she wanted to test a theory about being banned. So I had banned her to see something, and then I'm wondering if that's the reason why I didn't let you redeem first after I unbanned you and remodded you. I don't really know, but you would have had it. But instead, Storm sweeps in and gets it today. Welcome on in, Storm. How you doing? Thank you so much for popping in tonight. Scythe as well. It's good to see you. Good to see you with your rave emote. Hello, hello. How's it going? Also, Zelf. That wiggle emote is freaking adorable. And I hope you had a great time with Ace Attorney tonight. I was lurking for a bit during their stream playing some Ace Attorney. It's pretty pretty cool to listen to. The music was pretty fun in the area of the game that you were in when I was chatting. It was good. Also, what's going on, Red? Great to see you. Happy Sunday. Hope you're doing well. By the way, thanks for letting me know, Storm, that I was still on Gartic, so I did go ahead and fix that. But yeah, I went to the bathroom, I came back, saw the messages, and it was like, oh, well, oopsie daisies. also, hello, Haru! What are you magic at over there? Oh, hashtag ban shark. We'll ban Drew before we ban you, Shark. True, absolutely. You're not getting off the hook that easily there, Buster. Happy Sunnyside Update! Hey, hello, Chris! Happy Sunnyside Update to you as well. I saw you got some sushi earlier, so that's pretty exciting. I hope you otherwise had a good day. And howdy. Howdy, howdy, Zelf. Also, what's going on? I think I said hello to everybody. But if I didn't, what's going on? How you doing? Sigma, you're trying to find a new place in New York City to live. It's infinitely more stressful than anything this job is throwing at you, so I guess that's a good thing. Well, I guess it's a good thing that the job isn't as stressful. But I hope that finding the place becomes less stressful for you soon. I'm sorry to hear that's been a little bit stressful in the moment. But I hope it does get better for you. Your full sushi was too good? Oh, heck yeah! What were in the rolls? I'm fairly jealous. I actually was potentially going to have sushi this weekend because my buddy was visiting. So for those who didn't realize it, the reason why I was not live last night is because I had my friend here in town. And actually, the original plan was he was going to stay with me. I was going to sleep on the couch. He was going to probably take my bed or vice versa or whatever. The problem, though, is he is very allergic to cats and frankly would have struggled staying with me. And that was something that I knew he was allergic. I didn't quite know how bad it was, but it ended up working out okay because my old roommate, Sky, had a room at his apartment. So Graves stayed with him, so I didn't have him staying with me. But we were also out at this like speakeasy until like 12:30, 12:40. So I mean, by that time I basically just came back and went to sleep because I had about 3 hours of sleep the night before. So I did not stream yesterday, even though he didn't stay here, and it's just because I had plans. I was busy. So I hope you did have a good Saturday and a good Sunday as well, of course. You're madging because you have no more Splatoon 3 story to do. Well, you got some multiplayer stuff to do, right? Huh? Some fun stuff to do now that you're done with that, I hope. You're surprised about how much flexibility you have coming back from jobs that were nonstop slogs. Being back at the lab feels liberating. It'll probably feel more liberating when I don't spend 3 hours commuting in and out for the week. Yeah, that'll be better, because that's fucking terrible, frankly. That is an awful commute, so I apologize that that's what you're dealing with now. But I hope it gets better for you soon. And what's up, Pete? Pleasure to see you. How's it going? How is your weekend? I hope you're doing well. And yeah, thanks for popping in tonight. I'm about to get started with some Zelda. We're playing the Skyward Sword HD version, and I left off at the start of the second dungeon, so that's what we're about to do. All salmon all the time, and had some of the richest bluefin you've ever had. Oh, that sounds great. Ugh, I am jealous, Chris. We are going to have to get good sushi in California. Absolutely. We're going to have to do that. That'll be wonderful. Dylan, thank you for the host. Thanks for hanging. I appreciate it, man. And I hope you're well. Thank you so much. Thank you. What's going on? Also, do we confirm or deny our ban theory? Yeah, so the ban theory we were talking about is, does Twitch tell you who banned you if you get banned from a stream? Does it say if it was a mod? Does it say if it was whatever? Because we can see it, like, in mod view. Like, I can see who bans people. Or if I ban somebody. But can you, the person who's banned, see it? And the answer is no. You just see that you were banned. And I was testing it because I banned somebody recently. And it was in a stream that Chris was here. Because it was basically someone who had a chat message about, like... I don't even know if you saw this, Chris. Maybe you didn't. But it was like, you know, just some random first-time message of F Minoka Dobo and his mom or something like that. So I just immediately banned them and said, get the fuck out of my stream. And then they typed in, like, the unban request, and it was something like, I would have gotten away with it too if it wasn't for, you know, his mods and yada yada yada. But I banned him, so I was like, you probably didn't see who banned them. So I just was testing that out. But also, Natty, hello! Thank you for the host. How's it going? How was your day today? Remind me, how far into your PhD are you again? I am currently in my fifth year, and it's seeming more and more like I will be done by the end of the 2023... Oh shit, you're right! Oh god damn it, Chris, I forgot about that. Fuck! I forgot that. Damn! That might actually be a pain in the ass. Okay, we should... I don't know who I'm sharing with, but yeah, that's actually kind of a problem. Because only mods will see that happen, right? That's right. Dang, that might be a pain. But anyway, we gotta definitely try and figure that out. But yes, we did test that theory, and Sigma, I think I'll be done by the end of 2023. That's the hope, at least. But we will see. Also, TK Downey, thank you for the raid. What's going on? Welcome. How you doing? Thank you for coming on by tonight. I hope you had a great stream. And what were you up to tonight? What were you doing? Free Dom, free, yes. Free Dom, free indeed. Since we banned Dom... Yeah. When I asked, how are you feeling with your getting into Stealth overall? I still want to ask if Arkham Asylum and Hitman are on the table. Yeah, absolutely, man. I would play both of those. I think that'd be really cool. We were talking about Hitman the other day. That would be a fun one to try. I know that there's three games now, right? There's a Hitman 3. I don't know much about the other ones, but I've seen a little bit of that game. Some speedrunning, actually. But you were playing some Skyward Sword? Heck yeah! Well, I was the only person on Twitch playing Skyward? Really? Okay, well, I wonder if it's because they're in a different category. That's one possibility. But that's kind of interesting, actually. So I don't know how you were playing it. But it's my first playthrough of the HD version. I did play the regular standard one on the Wii a few years ago. I didn't play it growing up, but I played it on stream. And when this one came out, I had always thought, I'll stream this. I'll get to it eventually. And now is that eventually. And it's been great so far. It's been about a week since I last played it, though. So we'll see if I am rusty or not. But we're at the start of the second temple. There's like 8 games, but 3 in the new trilogy. Oh, okay, so there's like way more. Got it, Dylan. I got you, Storm. Gotcha. You never played the Wii, but this is your first time playing through it all the way. What do you think of it? What do you think of it so far? Yeah, actually, we need to figure that out. So, whose ban list did I share with? The reason why I'm worried, Dom, is it's like, you could be straight up banned and like... I don't know if Ope's accepted it, but like, you're gonna probably come to find And you got banned at a bunch of streams because of that. But let me see if I can figure out who I've shared with. I can hopefully try to do that. Thank you, Haru. You really do enjoy it. Oh, good. You don't care. But what if you're banned in a stream you want to be in? I guess we'll cross that bridge if we reach it, I suppose. That's fine. For the Hitman games, you do recommend the latest trilogy, but most of the games before the trilogy are pretty good to try as well. So there's no reason why I couldn't just jump into the new trilogy if I so chose, right? That's kind of what I'm hearing here, probably. But you really enjoy it. Well, good. I'm glad to hear that. Where are you at in the game? Since I have played it before, I just don't know. I have played it before. It's been a little while, so I would have a sense of where you're at in the game if you tell me. I'm curious. Skyward Sword is one of the few games in the series you haven't played. The others being Phantom Hourglass, Spirit Tracks, Link Between Worlds, and Traveler's Heroes. Yeah, so the ones that I haven't played Phantom Hourglass either, or Spirit Tracks. I did do Link Between Worlds. I have not done Four Swords or Four Swords Adventures. I also haven't done Triforce Heroes either. And I think that's it. I think I've played all the other ones, though. SMH, she's unbanned. Yeah, we were testing something, and then I just realized that that's what that did. It's okay, Storm. We can figure it out later, too. Seems like that's maybe what she wants to do. We can just deal with it later. So the reason why it's a feature... Yeah, so that part is dumb. Like, if you're being silly and, like, banning people to test something, it bans them in other shared lists. But the whole idea is, like, if I ban someone for being a shithead in my stream, then Haru doesn't have to ban that same person who could show up to her stream or something like that, you know? That's the idea behind it, but then in situations like this, then it just bans them in that chat, and it's like, oh, well, that's that's kind of a problem. So, you know, you've beaten both Four Swords games, but the particulars are hazy. Yeah, I never had. I actually was thinking about doing it years ago when I lived with people, because we thought it'd be a fun thing to do, like, couch co-op, but we just never did, frankly. So, that'd be cool to do sometime, though. I would like to play those. Although, how do you think those games are as, like, single-player games? Is it worth me just playing it by myself, or should I play it with other people, do you think? There's continuity, but all the games before the trilogy have their stories be contained enough that, for the most part, they can be played in any order. Got it, okay. So that trilogy in order, everything else kind of whatever, basically. That doesn't carry over, unfortunately, Shark. You only beat the DSi version of Four Swords? Because that one was originally on the GBA, correct? I think so. All four main Arkham games are a big recommend for you. I don't know which one that I've seen gameplay of before. We did! Yeah, I think we did. Yeah, I mean, years and years ago, like you said. So, it'd be fun to play again at some point. Also, by the way, I don't know if you can tell, but I did get some sun this weekend. You can probably see from my arm that, like, oh yeah, you can see the farmer's tan. Maybe on my chest. Oh yeah, you can kind of see around my neck a little bit. I played Frisbee Golf twice this weekend, actually. You're always red. Sorry, sweetie. Yeah, if I turn on these lights, I think it makes me look more pale. I think the white balance makes me look more pale with this. But maybe not. Maybe it'll keep me looking a little redder. I don't know. But yeah, it was fun. I had a really great time being outside this weekend. It was good. It did get me slightly crispy, though, so it is what it is. Anyway, I don't have a whole lot else to say. I did have a really nice weekend, and I'm happy to chat about it, too. Again, I did some Frisbee golf. I watched a movie this weekend, which I'll tell you all about that movie. It was fucking outrageous. I'll tell you about that. But I do want to get into the Zelda, because we didn't play it all yesterday since I wasn't live. I was, you know, really busy. And so I do want to get into it tonight and see if we can make some good progress. So I'm going to do that. We're going to swap on over. And we're going to go from there. All right, let's swap over. Let's get started. Let's do it. Wherever I can find my button. There we go. There we go. Drop shipping you sunscreen. I do have sunscreen. I was like, oh, I don't need to wear it today. I'm good. And that was a mistake. I definitely should have. But I don't feel like I'm going to burn too badly from this. But who knows? All right. Here we go. We're booting it up. So I know that... I know you had said TK Downey that you were rating because, like, you know, only other person playing this game, right? I guess I wasn't even playing it yet because I had... Oh, shit, I have to put the cartridge in. Because I was just starting my stream, actually, but we are about to get into it. So let me grab my cartridge. All right, just got to swap these out. Give me a sec. I was speedrunning Breath of the Wild, so I'll put you on my shared ban list too, Drew. Don't worry. Okay, perfect. Thank you. Thank you so much. Send. There we go. My cats are chasing each other. All right. All right, let's do it. Their red Joy-Con's very nice. Thank you. I have blue and green ones, but they drift, so I stopped using them because I needed them. Oh, because I need them for this game. Ah, right. Why did I grab this? I need my Joy-Cons. Well, I don't necessarily have to do the motion controls, but I want to. Okay, there we go. I have a pink one and a red one. That's what I'm using currently, so. Let's boot it up. Also, what's up, Colin? Your brother got second-degree burns from his trip to the beach last week. Almost had a bit of empathy for the kid. Almost. Almost. Not quite fully, but almost. There you go. It's natural camouflage for hiding the winter blizzards in the Rocky Mountains. There you go. I think that's a setting. Yeah. Yeah, what Chris said. You have the motion controls on your controller? Oh, use the motion controls on your controller to swing that around? Yeah, the fucking pro controller. There we go. Alright! I do have an autosave, but this should be the same save. We are at the start of the Earth Temple. We're gonna look for Zelda here. In the first temple of this game, we got the beetle, which I think is a pretty cool item. You know, fly it around and go find some stuff. I think it's pretty great. I did have a couple things I remembered I thought about doing, like, outside of the temple, like, in just Elden in general. I also know, too, that I had gotten a bunch of those stones activated, like, the big old, you know, cube ones. So I was thinking about going up to the surface and looking for those, but I think I just want to start by doing this. Let me see if I remember all my buttons, though. That was, sprint and then roll by shaking the... That works, that works. Look at the little dancing emote. I like that Harish emote. So I am using motion controls for this. I know that you don't have to necessarily, but I thought it was worth doing it with motion controls. Fly up there. I think this, yeah, we can't go this way yet. Oh, I can? Or maybe I need another one. Oh, no, I get it. I land on that, and then I can go on that one. Time to leave for my flight. Serenade me on the drive to BWI. Dude, I hope you fly safe. Shark's going to England, actually. I remember we were talking about it the other day. I hope it didn't end up being, like, super expensive for you, by the way. I'm scared of planes. Oh, you're going coach? Yeah, that's gonna be a rough one, yeah. Good luck. Good luck and fly safe. Hello. My partner's gone missing, and those red guys are everywhere. I never should have come here. Oh, it's you again. Come all this way in search of your friend, eh? Well, that reminds me. Before I came in here, I saw a weird-looking blonde girl get dragged away. That sounds like Zelda. Although, I don't know about weird-looking. But don't even dream about going to the rescue. Those baddies are everywhere. If you want to live again one day, you should head for home, pal. Oh, seeing this dude reminded me, too, of the route up here. There is a place that had a minigame that's essentially Minesweeper. But, damn, you can make so much of a profit playing that game. That might be my rupee farming method. Yeah, when the news about the queen came out, Shark said I might be flying to England. Oh, that was a bad jump. That was not a very good jump. Oh my god, cats, please don't chase each other behind my fucking computer. Shark is being crowned. What's up, Sprint? All hail Shark. King Shark. First of his name. Hey, what's going on, AOL? It's good to see you. How are you tonight? I saw you had a new VTuber, by the way. I saw something on Twitter about it. I gotta check it out in action. Let's see. Oh, I think I have to shoot those, maybe? Oh, yeah. Like, if I do, Oh, maybe I have to cut him down with the beetle. That might actually be what we have to do. Shark, new king. Can you tell them to let me back in England? Drew's stream isn't the only place I was banned. Yeah, they did decide to keep her out of the whole country, so if you could help out with that, I'm sure she would appreciate it. Also, 24 shrines completed. Very nicely done. Are you still having fun with it, Sprint? With Breath of the Wild? Master, I am detecting new enemies ahead. They appear to be creatures of very significant physical ability. Alright. Guns aren't allowed in England, Dom. I know it's your god-given right as a text to have a gun. More than in my hand. Yeah, from Dragon Quest. Yeah, obviously. Are you new king of England? Oh, oops. That's not what I wanted. That's what I wanted. Target lock, Lizalfos, the land of the king. This unmistakable monster is equipped with an arm guard made of hard iron. Great physical prowess makes it difficult to predict its movements. You will need to anticipate the direction of its right arm guard to successfully land an attack on the exposed angle. You've defeated zero of these. I guess I'd like... How'd that not work? How does that... Oh, I see. That one wouldn't have worked. That's a higher up. Lower. Wow, that was way harder than I thought it would be. I have 19 minutes until my laptop dies. Can you do the dungeon before then? Okay, I will do my best. That I can promise you. What about your phone? Don't you have Twitch on your phone? But I will do my best. That I will promise you. Okay, so there's a couple bombs here. A couple bomb flowers. I feel like... Oh, I think I have to carry them over and blow things up. I have to write a 200-word essay for tomorrow. Can you do the dungeon before I need to start? I know some things he does very quickly, and it's not Breath of the Wild. Damn. Brutal. I think I can pick these up, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe I just hit it? I was pretty sure there was a way that I could pick those up. Mario's really quick too. That's a lot of smiley faces, Scythe. She opens up on her phone. How she can distract herself from her stream? Fair questions. I think I have to roll on this, like balance it, or do I just run? Oh, I actually way prefer that. That's a lot nicer. Oh right, I gotta throw it like that. That didn't work. I'm watching Tiki Talks. Okay, well that's not gonna do it. That's gonna explode too fast. There we go. God damn it. Oh my god. Okay. I'll just wait. Fee, I don't need... It's fine. You don't have to try to help me here. I got this. Did that really blow up like 2 seconds too fast? That's a travesty. Drew, when you started streaming, did you realize it was going to devolve into you being in Blast every night? Oh, it fell. Oh, I see. Do you want the brutally honest answer, or do you want the... Yeah, of course, obviously. A golden skull. I think I found one of those already. There's a semi-serious answer. Goodness, Link's so ugly. I know you're not about it, Zreika. There has to be a keel, and usually it's true. The brutally honest answer is I got onto Twitch because I felt things lacking in my personal life with the friendships that I had. Nothing against those friends now. Wait, there we go. But it was like I wanted to experience something that I was passionate about, but in a more wholesome environment from people who didn't already know me. I felt like growing up and for a lot of my friendships, I was always the butt of every joke. And I was pretty tired of it. And I kind of got into Twitch because I wanted to have wholesome, fun experiences with games and people who didn't already know that about me, or that wasn't already established in a way. We are easy on this guy compared to what you have to go through. There were literally some times where I had to leave because of how people were treating you. Yeah, I think it's definitely not, like, everything now, like, I'm cool with it. Like, nothing anyone is saying tonight is making me, like, God, I want to end my fucking stream. But, I mean, there were times where that wasn't always the case. There were a lot of times, too, just on this subject, too. There were times when I was streaming where people were, like, real, like, pushing some serious boundaries in terms of, like, there we go. Like, what was appropriate to say to me. For instance, people talking about jerking off to me in my chat, unironically. It's like, I don't need to know that. I don't need to hear that. You know, people coming in assuming things about me because of what I looked like or what I sounded like. And, that shit made me uncomfortable. Yeah, sorry about that. it's okay. It's all water under the bridge now. So, I mean, did I predict that? No, that I didn't predict. I did not predict that streaming retro games in the middle of the night, looking like the way that I looked, I truly didn't think that that was what I was going to attract. And it was, at the time. A lot of fucking horny guys who thought I was a twink and thought they could say stuff like that to me. And of course, when you're just starting streaming, it's like, if you don't know any better, it's like, oh, well, these people are here watching me. I have to entertain that to some aspect. Not like play into it, but like not ban them. And then I set more boundaries at a certain stage. I started putting up with less and less at some stage, you know? Hey, you know, we're not all doing that right now. Because with a message like that, you gotta be typing it with two fins, Shark. Also, am I supposed to grab a bomb and come over here with it? Because I assume I'm blowing this thing up. But maybe it's a different spot where I will get it from. In my opinion, a joke is always at someone's expense. The key is not take it too far. It'd be cool and it's eventually at yours. I definitely have a lot of, like... Shark! That's funny. I joke at my own expense pretty often. I mean, we all have, like, a certain level of tolerance at the end of the day, right? I mean, we can only put up with so much. But I've got fairly thick skin, and I can laugh at myself, and I don't mind people laughing at me either.
It's really Drew's fault. I climbed up on the top of Pulpit Rock today via a way I couldn't get down.
Pulpit Rock?
And there was no one to help me down, and I was just stuck up there with, you know, rocks and my thong up my ass waiting for someone to come rescue me.
Did someone rescue you? Did someone rescue you? We got a cliffhanger. Well, I guess you typed that message, so you must have... Someone must have come and helped you out. Came and helped you out. Whoa! Well, Skyra, what the heck? I think I have to hit that one too, maybe. I forgot how you do this dungeon, this part, but I think that's right. I'm stuck detonating for the top of the rocks. R.I.P. I hope someone comes and helps you out soon. Okay. I think as long as you don't just move too much in one direction, you're good here. Do I have to go... Maybe I can't do it from this one, frankly. Part of it is learning to not sacrifice the vibe for a viewer. Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. That's a... And I think I just saw AOL. You said, too, you ban people for making you feel uneasy or anxious even if they did nothing. That is... That's... I mean, that's what I've found to be the best way, too. From others' experiences and in just my own. Learning that, like, you do not have to put up with... Oh, do I roll it under something? I'm just trying to remember what you do here. But I think I have to roll that back over. And then... Yeah, maybe I have to go underneath. Or I can't go underneath that. Because I don't think I can... Oh, can I jump? That's what I don't remember. I can't jump with this thing. I don't remember what I did with this. Maybe let's... Oh, that's where we came from. Let's just keep going and see if I can figure it out. Sorry, let me catch up from and chat really quick. Some people need to go to horny jail, a couple actual jail, literally. What I mean to say that is it's cool to make fun of us, too. Yeah, no, of course. I mean, here's the thing. If I know you, at least, you know, as much as I can from being in my stream for a while or whatnot, And, like that's something that's established. Like, I don't mind teasing back. If it's someone random or something like that, I don't really want to do that ever. The other thing, too, is I tend to be a little bit more cautious on that because what if someone comes into my chat and they're like, wow, this streamer is bullying this person for saying something harmless. I don't think I want to hang out here. This doesn't seem like a great stream to be in. Because they don't realize that, like, me and the person I'm talking about are cool. So I do sometimes, I don't know, think it's fair to be cautious on that. Also, I don't remember. Can I make this thing go any higher? I'm trying to remember what you do with this thing. Just jump up off the top of the rocks and death warp back to the bottom. Oh, there we go. Try pressing the jump button at the top of the jump for the longest glide. Ugh, classic Scott Spyro. I almost said Skyro again. No one should be sexually harassing poor Drew. No one should sexually harass anybody. I agree. I thought I could pick it up with these. I thought you could do that, but maybe I am misremembering this. Oh, God. Hold on, I have to recenter this. Tippy-tap, tippy-tap, tippy-tap. Let's see, pointing it middle. Okay, let's try this. Oh, God. Now it just lights it off. I must be misremembering this. I really thought there was a way that you could, like, launch a bomb at these things. Or, like, drop one on it from somewhere. We just scout around a little bit. Can I make this thing go any higher? No one should be harassing anyone. True. There is a chest over here. Remember how I go over this way, though. Let me see if I can get back. You just gotta think with portals! Ah, now we're talking. Oh, wait. Is that something that I cut to? On this end? Or no, that was... Okay, no, never mind. Oh, I don't think I've come over here yet. Let's come here. Let's come over here. Hi, Led. Blast, I must have dropped it earlier. Hey, nice timing, pal. It's me, Led. You showing up here must mean we're connected somehow. You know, like fate or something. Anyway, do me a favor and get my bomb bag, okay? I was behind that rock looking for treasure when those creeps showed up. I panicked and hit the road, but it looks like I dropped it. It's a bag for carrying around bomb flowers. I can't imagine not having one. Oh, hey, I guess I'm gonna have to imagine it, because I lost mine. Anyway, it's back there. Do me a favor and get my bomb bag back, will ya? Happily. I think I roll this up against him and go from there. Hi! Her ass. Blah, his ass. Oh, yeah. I'm glad, Aeol and Chris, you both said it. Yeah, you definitely think about it similarly to how I do. You shouldn't have to put up with it. Even if someone's like, well, that's not fair. That's not against your rules to blah, blah, blah. It's like, well, too bad. It's my fucking stream and I feel uncomfortable. Goodbye. I really struggled with that, though. For a while, I had a hard time. Oh, where's my empty bottle? Shit. Oh, I don't have an empty bottle. Okay. I definitely put up with more than I should have initially. Beautiful. There we go. We're not paying up to put up with people's nonsense reader party, and if you can't behave, you bounce. Well said. Hey, what's up, Spencer? It's good to see you. Been hopping 7 around. Just been super busy. No worries. I hope your job is going well. I was going to bring my friend in to see you, but we just didn't end up getting any coffee. But I got to pop by your cafe sometime. That'd be fun. We get paid? Well, some could say it's the only reason I'm still around. What are you talking about? There's lots of reasons you're allowed. Around. And allowed. Cracking their shoulders. Was that both of them? Oh, a lizard tail. 2 days. Tired of sleeping, have positive, or time of sleeping. Sounds good. Sleep well. Thanks, Skyra. I appreciate you. Oops. I gotta go low there. Or just do that. There we go. Sleep well, Skyro. I appreciate you, man. Speaking of pay, Drew, tell your mom that the check didn't come in the mail, and I'll have to unfollow if it doesn't get here by the 15th. I will let her know. I'll tell her. That the check to pay for your viewership should be coming in soon. And it is my mother who funds that. You found a bomb bag! Carry bombs. There's a good chance you can explore places that you haven't been able to yet. So see if Led will lend it to you. I sure hope that he will. Otherwise, I don't know what we will do. Yay! I think we can buy something back up in Skyloft now. Probably an upgrade to it. Hey, you found my bomb bag! Sorry to put you through that. I guess I owe you one now, so let me have it. What is this now? You want to borrow it so you can go deeper in the volcano? All right, you're looking for your friend. You sure put yourself out there getting this far. That reminds me, how's my pal? I saw him, I think, on the other side. He's worried. Kill him if he doesn't let you. sorry, buddy, it's you or me. He's worried about me? What kind of pal am I putting him through that? You must be worried too, not knowing if your friend's dead or alive. I'm not letting you borrow my bag though. Nope. I'm giving it to you. Just don't blow yourself up. Thank you. Bum 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 bum. Yeah, start using the word check. Shark, you're going to England. Beans and toast time! Woohoo, enjoy! Please don't jump on my PS3. She jumped on my PS3. Why is waiting for checks in the mail still a thing? My school double charged me and I've been waiting for a week and a half for a check back. Ugh! Disgusting. What about, like, direct deposits? Bomb baggy, woohoo! Now you got my bomb bag. Go find your friend. Good. Let her do it. I forgot to tell you something. You know me, that bag's probably empty, so let me give you a little something to get started. I hope she jumps on all the PSs, but not the Switch. Which consoles do you want her to not jump on? Go deeper into my volcano, TBH. Someone in chat, probably. That is awful. What's going on, Caitlin? If you're out of bombs, just find some more and I'll fill the bag back up. When you got a bomb flower, press B to put in the bag. Don't forget, that bag can hold up to 10 bombs. Alright, well, there was some in here, so... Jeez, let's just play the game for us, then. Go in the bag, please. Also, can someone explain to me? Am I just getting rid of the fuse? Or, like getting rid of the, you know, the flame that's currently fucking igniting this thing? Someone explain to me how that works. Ooh, how's Splatoon been? Sounds like folks have been really enjoying Splatoon 3 so far. I hope you've been enjoying it as well. Alright, so let's see. So over here, I don't know if I can blow that up or if I'm going to have to just backtrack and come back for it. But I do know I can blow this up. Zinnia, what are you doing back there? Please? Yay. Oh, it's vacuum sealed. No air, no flame. The flame makes Link's leg sweat, therefore putting out the fuse. Okay, Zinnia's right in front of my monitor. Oh, it's your first one. I actually haven't really played much of one either. I tried Splatoon 2 out at a PAX convention. Oops. That was my only experience with it. That was awkward. No shout that doesn't keep rolling. Right? I actually didn't think that was going to work. I was like, if this doesn't explode right away, this isn't working. I like these mulmets. I also like that you don't have to equip them. They're just already on there. Kind of nice, honestly. Oops. That's not good. Let's splat, Drew. Yeah, I'm down to play with you. Would you play it? Is that what people say when they want to play Splatoon? Hey, do you want to splat? No, but thank you. Okay. Alright. Hold on, let me get my shield out. Was it this one? That didn't work. Can I slingshot him? Or maybe I bomb him. Maybe that's what I do. Ah, there we go. That makes sense. That timing worked out well. Hi, Zinni. Do you want to come over? What you doing? She says, I'm roaming around. You've played it since before it released. How are you playing it before it released? How'd you manage to do that? Well, that worked. Oop. There we go. Hi, Zinnia. The little sassy tail flicks. I hope this is the map. First mobile test fire, the beta test, so that makes sense. What's going on, Dustin? Welcome on in, my boy. How was your stream tonight? Thank you so much for coming by. We're playing some Zelda. We're in the second dungeon in the game, and we just got the map. So thank you so much, and thank you, Navy, for coming in too. What's up, Fat Cat? Splatoon before going to the skate park is called the old Splat and Scat. And you get a big old splatting scab when you fall at the skate park. That'd be me. Fun fact, I did go... the only time in my life that I actually skated at a skate park, I was in elementary school. It was not on a skateboard. It was on a scooter. And my mom came with me to watch to make sure I didn't get hurt. But I didn't go on, like, the half pipe or anything like that. I just had, like, a little hill I would roll down. That's what I got to do. I was a scoot kid because I had a protective mother. Well, that was weird. But it worked. Skyward Sword, you love this game. You're alert to avoid spoilers. I don't remember too much from Skyward Sword. Have a good stream. Thank you so much. I hope... Oh, that was dumb. That was not smart of me. That was not smart of me. But anyway, yes, I was a scoot kid because of my protective mother. Now I ride a skateboard. Maybe because I couldn't as a kid. Actually, not really. I just like it, but... Mood. You liked my Razor Scooty. I liked mine too, but yes, it was not protective of my ankles. Yeah, the number of times that thing, you know, swings around and smacks the hell out of your ankles. Shit hurts. That's how I feel if it has wheels. I gotta give it a try. Anything with wheels, huh? Scoot. Kids afraid to leave his scoot. Scoot. Alright, let's see. Where do we want to go here? So, if we could bring this ball around here, that would be great. As much as you've tried, you can't skateboard. Yeah, there you go. You got the scootimo. I'm surprised I still have my ankles after being hit so many times with my razor. Yeah, right? That's brutal to your ankles, isn't it? I don't think I blow this up, but just... I'm going to try and see if it works, because I don't remember. Maybe it does work. Yeah, I didn't think so. I think I just have to blow something else up. Maybe it's, like, one of these? It's, like, move it? I can't remember. Do I roll on this and then blow something up while I'm rolling, maybe? Balance just doesn't keep. You actually don't mind scooters, it's just the scoot kids that get in the way. Same as surfing. I've never tried to surf before, but I feel like I would be bad at it, but if I could get it, I think it'd be fun. I don't know if I can get this anywhere down, frankly. Let's maybe backtrack a moment. I don't know if there's anything else that I can get now that I have bombs. Let me go back really quick. Because maybe. Let's just see. I learned to try to learn to skate as a post-breakup crisis. You didn't get very far, but mentally, you're feeling better now and you're addicted to lifting, so maybe I'll give skating another shot next summer. You know what? Spencer, we can lift together and I'll show you how to skate. How's that sound? I don't think there's anything else back here, actually. You're all for at surfing, but it comes where you grew up. You love skating and snowboarding, though. I tried to snowboard. I'm not great at it. I'm a skier. That's my preferred winter sport. Yoked Druby Arc. I've told this story before, but the last time that I went to the gym regularly, I had a personal trainer. It was pre-pandemic. And one out of every three workouts, I would throw up. It did not matter what I ate beforehand. It didn't matter how hard we worked out. But it probably did to some extent. But I just felt terrible. I wonder if I blow this up. Ah, Shark knows where the story is going. Yeah, y'all have heard this. I'll give you the very short version for Spencer's sake. Long story short, Spencer, I worked out super hard. One day I threw up at the gym, embarrassed the hell out of myself, and I basically didn't go again. Or I didn't go much longer after that. It was embarrassing. And the woman working out near me said, "Don't be a pussy today." And then that happened, and she said, "Oh, I guess you weren't being a pussy today." It was lovely. I skipped the good part. Yeah, I didn't say too many details there, did I? I feel like I should be able to go... I gotta think about how this works. Also, thank you for the follow. Welcome in. Wait, let me see what you said, Fat Cat. You've had Skyward Sword since the release date. You haven't finished it only because I don't want to have to go through the postpartum of beating a game. Felt that. Yeah, that did happen. Yep, that is how it went. Storm said the critical detail there. You started going to the gym 2 weeks and you already feel more energized? I thought that was a myth. No, it's real, man. I gotta get back into it too, frankly. I appreciate lack of details. My stomach's been yucked today. Do you think you ate something funny or funky or just... What do you think has got you feeling that way? I'm starting to hear that, though. Somebody finds places too? Heck yeah! Need any tips? I will let you know if I do. I have played this game before, but it was a while ago. So I don't really remember a lot of details of how to do things. But... I like to try to figure it out as best as I can. And I might not, but I want to try at least. And see how far I can make it. But, yeah, this room I'm sort of struggling with currently because I'm forgetting what you're supposed to do. I did get the bomb back, but... Now, when you played this game, had you played the original Black Sheep Slush? Or was this your first experience with Kyra's Sword? Because I did play the original years ago, and I really enjoyed it. Yeah, I know I have to blow this up so I can roll this boulder here. You're a massive Ghirahim sim? Yeah, so is my girlfriend. It's wild how working out and sleeping properly... Yep, there she is. Felt that. Yep. Okay, I don't remember how I get the shit over. I feel like I have to bring the water the lava level up higher so I can go over that. Maybe I blow these other things up. I don't know. I think I should roll and pick up some other bombs and maybe try that. That's my guess, but I just don't remember. Or did I screw myself over by hitting that? I feel like that lowered it. So I think that's... I don't know. Jim has been amazing for mental. I promise to be nice, encouraging, and hopefully keep you from... Yeah, I appreciate that. No, I appreciate that. I don't know, Spencer, how you're motivated, like, when you work out or just in general. I'm definitely, I'm motivated by encouragement. I'm demotivated by people calling me a pussy. And for some people, that's not the case. Some people, it's like, they need that, and they push themselves harder. Not me. That just makes me never want to work out with you again. Oh, fuck. Sorry, looks amazing. I was stoked when the HD came out because it's the only Zelda you've ever played. Oh, I see. So the only one that you've never beaten. What's your favorite Zelda, then, if you don't mind me asking? I feel like I have to blow some of these things up. I'm just trying to remember. Do I blow this up more? And Metal Gear Rising? Hell yeah. No, not that. I feel like I do have to break something for this to work. I just remember what it is. Yep. There she is. Yep. There's the quill. I don't think I can roll through this. That's the thing. Pretty sure I'm just straight up blocked here. The black hole in my chest. Remember this. And how you doing, Kenny? Welcome in, man. How is it going? Do I break something from the ceiling and then it drops down? I just don't remember this, frankly. You're motivated by anger and resentment. Sorry, let me see what that said, Shark. Fuck you, I'm gonna be better. You have actually, not to expose you, you've said that to me before in regards to a previous relationship. It motivated you, because it's like... Yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about. I guess you can finally finish it, because you're about half a year away from the release of the sequel to Breath of the Wild. I hope it's only half a year away. Anger also motivates me. What's up, Drew and Jay? What's up, Jay? How you doing, my man? Jay, how's the Mario going? Learning some tricks. I hope that's been fun still. I would still love to play that with you sometime. just remember what I'm supposed to do here. Twilight Princess HD is my favorite. Twilight Princess is my favorite game too, actually. Let's see if there's anything that looks like I could break. I feel like there's something I have to break. Like a weak spot somewhere. I thought it was this. Boop! Take that. I'm doing pretty all right. How's Splatoon 3 going? You've been taking a slight break for an hour, so you're getting so angry. Are you still trying to bomb clip? Because that will happen. Bomb clip is hard. I love to play. I need the help. Yeah, man. I'm down. I'm very down. Let's see. I feel like I have to blow this up. JJ, time to play more Toy Princess. Go back over to the blocked area and blow up the wall. So that is what I need to do. Did I blow this one up? No. Maybe I blow that part up. Oh, maybe I get onto the boulder and I roll over there. Let's try it. And then I can blow that up. That might be actually what we're supposed to do. Let me look at the map. I think that's what we do, actually. Let's try it. On top of it, maybe? Like, up there? There's an X on the wall? Oh, I see it now. Right there. Got it. Ah, there we go. That'll do it. So now I can go over that area. Oh, I just go through here. I thought it might rise up the lava level. How are you, Jay? Oh. Yeah, that shit is not easy, though. Bomb clip is really hard. Have you, watched a full run of it yet, Jay? Alright, let's put that in. Yeah, thank you. Most games, if it's my first time playing it, I don't generally like to be told how to do things unless I ask. I have played this game before. And even with this, it's like, oh, I'll generally ask. But, like, I was struggling with that for a bit, so I was pretty close to asking anyway, frankly. Splat on me, TBH. I think these days, well, I haven't played in a while, but I would say that when I was playing pretty consistently, I hit bomb clip 80-90% of the time, but initially it was like 20. Oops. There we go. You're right on the story, but as soon as you're done with that, the true grind begins to grind your levels. What do you think of the PvP so far, Kenny? Oh, you watched my VODs of it. Oh, cool. Just so I can know you better, which two-color Magic the Gatherer guild are you? Why do you think that? Okay. All right, here's my answer for you, Spencer. I'll tell you what colors I play the most of, and then I'll tell you what colors I think I am. By far, my most common color combo, two-color combo color, is Dimir. Black-blue. Most of the decks I play are black-blue. And basically every single, not every, but basically every deck I have has blue in it. But not all of them, most of them do. I feel like blue works for me because I am like an inquisitive person. I do research, I like to study things. I feel like blue is an accurate one for me. I think I have to blow another wall up or something to get this past here. The question is, where might that be? Or maybe I don't think I climbed this. So I'd say that's my first color. I think my second color is probably like, maybe like white, like realistically speaking. I don't love Azurius decks, but I feel like white blue is probably most accurate to me. Oh, there it is. I see it now. I gotta pay attention for those little cracks in the wall. When you get back to Mario, I don't know. Seeing other people getting into it, Natty and Jay are both playing it. It makes me want to play it again. There we go. White green top tier. White green can be fun to play. This map also shows stuff like that. I feel like that this game does that. It makes that feel a little bit like a useful item. Yeah, like I could have looked to see like, there's a little passage there. Mario Luigi Superstar Saga. That would be pretty cool. I should play those games on stream. Azorius is your guild, your preacher to the choir. Oh, cool. Okay, good. Good, good, good. Well, you and I have that in common then. Let's see. I probably just climb this. Oh, I hit that, actually. Do you think Mario's going to take you back after all the history you shared? Someone's got to keep him warm at night. And it's not going to be Peach. She's too busy doing other things. He'll take me back. Now, I think I can just... Can I jump over that side? Can I... I don't know if I can do that or not. I probably have to, like, launch it over it and... Yeah, that might be what I have to do. Take my beetle, fly over it, and do that. Oh, she's probably gonna press my lights. You're probably about to see a light color change. You're having so much fun getting into Mario? Where are you at with it right now, Natty? What tricks you've been working on? Or, I'm gonna be honest, too. Like, even if you don't want to do tricks, but you just do things like... Oh, I want to learn how to do... You know, like, the wall kick star... Like, you can even do that in a very vanilla way if you want to. You don't have to be super fancy with it. And I feel like that's a great thing about that game as a speedrunning game is you can do basic, very basic movement and still do a speedrun of the game. You just have to learn the major glitches. You have to learn how to BLJ. You have to learn how to do MIPS. But, like, there's a lot of stuff you definitely don't have to learn. Oop, wrong side. There we go. Jesus. There we go. For me, it's because I'm a pretentious glasses pusher guy who bricked the 5 counter spells in hand. That's fair, frankly. That's fair. I just like drawing cards. I like drawing cards and casting spells. I feel like Izzet is a good combo for me. But I feel like Dimir just has cool cards. And flavor-wise. So, I mean, 3-color is Grixis then, which I feel like is, like, such an edgy fucking combo. Or Grixis or blue-green-black, I also really like. I feel like I should play more Golgari things, but I just haven't. Okay, let me... Yeah, Natty's doing it too, man. Also... Oh, right, I just have to time this. I'm gonna wait for this next one and then go for it. Dude, box clip. Jeskai Gamer, that's right, thank you. Is this the swaggiest red guild? I'm an Esperoid at heart. Ah!
Jeskai Gamer.
Yes. Esper's cool too. Which makes sense, because you like Azorius, so that makes sense you like Esper. Sky, how you doing tonight? Dude, The Hobbit? I would learn that with you. Although that does seem actually hard to speedrun. Wait, let me get that out. Grixis is Esper but with black Air Force Ones on. That's such a funny way to describe it. I've always wanted a good Esper deck. I have like a couple of cool cards that I feel like work well with it. And I want something cool with artifacts. And I don't have a deck that's got, like, fun artifact stuff yet. Just equipment. I've always thought about, like, a Brea deck. Obviously, she's, like, a very common one to choose for that. But she's also 4-color, but... There we go. Oh, the roulette grind. Nice. Nice, nice. Did you say you got Reaper to 90, or are you still working on getting it to 90? I feel like having a live person getting be help best helpful. Well, if you want, we could co-stream it. I help you out and actually speaking of co-streams, I mentioned this to Natty and Jay and Harley already. As you may or may not know, you probably know because I've been talking about it a bit. I've been playing old school RuneScape with them off stream. I want to go for a fire cape. And if you don't know what that is, it's an item that you get by doing this challenge that's considered to be like an iconic RuneScape challenge. I've never actually gotten one before. They're hard if you don't know what you're doing, but they're, you know, not that bad once you learn it. But I thought about streaming that with them, or like if they'd be up for that, or like doing that. Is that something people would even watch, or is that something that we should just do in like a Discord call or something? That's all I was gonna ask. Hey, we got one of those. Once again, throwing Simpsons Hit and Run out there as a fun speed game. You would be the person to teach us, Colin. If you love to learn Bomb Clip for the first starter, then you need to figure out what's next after that. Well, I would say don't beat your head at it too much. Because, you can always pound that pole. You can always pound that pole, and you don't lose that much time. You lose some, but not that much. RE2 Remake, let's go. Yeah, I want to watch you speedrun that. As for Legends are so lame, largely, like, I personally like combats, so the pickings are slim. I had that too! I felt like there weren't as many cool Esper commanders. Don't roll a boulder on me. Oh, I see. Oh, I get it. Okay. Oh, I see. If I stop sprinting at all, I'm screwed. I knew I was getting quoted. Well, you were correct. And serious, I'm great. How are you doing? I had a really good weekend and a good day. Oh, am I gonna just run out of energy going up here? Maybe it's not what I'm supposed to do. Okay, let me try this one more time and see if I can do it. You'll never forget getting curb stomped by an artifact mirror deck. Yeah, they're things. Those decks can be brutal. Skylar has a pretty wild artifact deck. I see. You basically take these artifacts that on their own are garbage, but you get a lot of value out of them with the commander that you play, and then you can set up a bunch of infinite combos and win that way. It's a cool deck. For those who know Magic, it's an Emery deck that he plays. Not Ozgear, surprisingly, but he actually did use... he did used to have an Ozgear deck, but he broke it apart and put it into some other decks. I'd love to do a Fire Cape call regardless. Yeah, me too. Stream or no stream, I think we should do a call. I don't think I'm ready to stream it, even if I'm learning. That's fair. What do you think it makes a fun speed game? The only ones you've considered learning are Mega Man, Z3, or Cage 2. I think what makes a fun speed game is... I mean, you gotta like the game first off, which of course is like an unspoken... I mean, it's like it's a given. I think what makes a fun speed game is if there's a lot of room for growth with it. Like, rather than you learn this one cool trick and then it's just like, you know, optimizing your movement to doing it. Or like the trick is really hard to pull off and then you have to reset a bunch. I think fun speed games have like tiers with it where you could start playing the game and just feel cool by... That's why I like Super Mario 64. It's like, wow, I did a BLJ. I just skipped getting a shit ton of stars. Like, that's cool. But you could do pretty much normal movement for the whole thing. A really low floor, I think, is a fun speed game. And then having the potential to look just fly as hell playing it. Like, you watch a really good 16-star run, and it's like, their movement just looks so satisfying. I think platformers in general are good speed games too, because, for me at least, it's just satisfying to do that well. But I know folks who speedrun, like, RPGs and things like that too. Actually, one person who is going to TwitchCon, who I've hung out with before, Dash Retro, he speedruns Final Fantasy VII, which is like, you know, I think his PB is around like 7 hours, which is like, my god, that is outrageous. Like, he loves it. And it's cool to see the fun glitches you can do and the optimization of things. But for me, kind of short and sweet, movement looks cool, and like a lot of room to get better. That's like my criteria. You'd work this weekend, but your job was relatively easy, so it wasn't that bad. Are you off for some days this week though, serious, or do you have to You have to work, like, tomorrow. Oh, yeah, Sky, I don't know if you've seen Spencer in chat yet, but that's him. That's Spencer. I see how I do this. Yeah, you store the bomb flowers in this game, which is kind of interesting. Okay, a little bit higher. Yeah, that's the Spencer at our LGS. That's him. I'd love to learn more if you're up for it, Drew. I really appreciate it. Yeah, I would be down. That'd be cool. You work all week, by the way, but you'll probably get the whole next weekend off. Oh, that's good. Are you a cop? Yeah, Sky and I would have gone back probably this weekend if we didn't have our friend visiting. And he had a concert he went to, too. We're going to play Commander with one of our buddies this weekend. But we'll get back to the cafe soon, I'm sure. Hey, what's up, Kodadon? How you doing? I vaguely remember what's gonna happen. Also, we've been actually doing all right in here. We're killing it. We're almost done with this dungeon, actually. Eric! Thanks for the raid! Thanks to the Not Real Eric raid. How's it going, everybody? Let me just give you a handy little shout out. And we'll see what you're up to tonight. Thank you so much. Ah, that's a great game. Marvel Spider-Man, the 2018 Spider-Man game. I played that on stream and I loved it. I hope you're enjoying it too. What's up, Ghost Dog? Thanks for coming in. Eric, how you doing? Yeah, I always appreciate seeing y'all drop by in a raid. So thank you so much. We're playing Skyward Sword tonight. This is a Zelda game that I played the original of on the Wii. Not, you know, when it came out, but through streaming. And I was really excited to play this game. But I just hadn't picked it up yet, so it was time to play another Zelda game, and this is the one that we're playing, so. Yeah, first time with the HD, so it's great. It's great. We're in the second dungeon currently. First time playing Spidey, it's sweet. Where are you at in the game? Alright, so I thought this boss was pretty cool, by the way. I think I'm supposed to, like, roll this bomb down or something. I don't remember. I think I have to, like, launch it off or something, but maybe it's not there. It might be further down. Oh, I remember now. I remember now. Hey, Noe, thank you for raiding. And Evan, what's going on? Oh. Nice. There you go. Evan, how you doing tonight? Great to see you. We're about to go kick a fire dragon's ass. Crunch! And thanks for the host, Chris. He's at the part where Peter doesn't want to eat any more webs, and he has to, or Green Gabo will cry. He's like, I've eaten every last web I've shot out in cleaning up this city. And I can't take it anymore. You need to head to bed because you've worked in like 6 hours. It was awesome seeing you. Have a great rest of the stream. Thank you. I appreciate it. Sleep well. I hope work goes all right tomorrow. Frankly, I don't know. I shouldn't be up too late tonight myself because I also work in the morning. But not 6 hours. It's like 11:30 for me. And I need to get up at like 8. 7:30 or 8. I feed my cats at like 7 a.m. But I get up for work at around like 8 or so. So it's not too bad. But yeah, you have a good one. Thank you so much for coming in with Eric tonight. So you just started. You met up, saved Mary Jane after introduction. Prepare for a fun ride. I really, really enjoyed that game. And yeah, like I said, I hope that you like it too. Oh, I see. It's going to go like this. There we go. Cool. You played some Monster Hunter, Evan. Nice. My day was good. Oh yeah, there were a bunch of things I was going to talk about with this weekend that I just haven't yet. But my buddy was visiting. Sky can attest to a lot of this too, because we were hanging out for a lot of it. We played Frisbee Golf twice, which was really fun. I watched a movie with Graves called Barbarian. It's a brand new horror movie that came out. We saw it in theaters. Have any of you heard of it before, or worse, have any of you seen it? Just curious. I won't spoil anything to you all. but I just want to know if you've heard of it or if you've seen it. You saw a trailer for it? Oh, good night, Daddy. Sleep well, man. Trailer art? Okay. I think I remember sort of how this goes. All I hear is go into it blind as possible? Yes. I will say very little then. I'll say very little then. You love that game too, apart from the funny Jeopardy that occurred that I told you about in DMs? Yes. Yeah, Spencer. You did tell me about that. You're going to watch that on Tuesday. Were you? Okay. All right. Okay. I'm not going to spoil anything. Here's what I will say about Barbarian. What the trailer will tell you, so I'm not spoiling anything in addition to that, is that there is a woman who is staying at an Airbnb, and she shows up there, and there's somebody who's there who's not supposed to be. It's her Airbnb, but he's also there, and he thinks that it's his Airbnb. And all you check all the paperwork, and they're both there. And so they're at this Airbnb. He's not supposed to be there, but she is, and it's a horror movie. That's all I will say. I would love to talk about spoilers because I've been wanting to talk about this movie for a while, but I'm not going to do so because, of course, I'm not going to spoil it for any of you. But it is wild. Whether you like it or you don't like it, I will say it is an incredibly memorable movie. It's very memorable. Self-aware and memorable. That's what I will say. So let me know if you... DM me, tell me if you see it, and I want to hear what you think about it, if you watch it. Yeah, you saw the trailer too, Spencer. So you sound like against watching it, or it was actually good. I think if you like horror, you should watch that movie. If you like horror, watch it. If you don't like horror, you will not like this movie. It is a horror movie. It's a horror movie, for sure. Master, I detect Zelda's aura in the surrounding area. I detect an especially strong reaction from this chain. I calculate the probability Zelda was bound by it recently at 95%. You know, James Gunn liked it. It seems like critics really enjoyed it, too. Yeah, you saw the trailer? Yeah, let me know if you see it, Chris. I surmise Zelda was somehow able to escape and proceed along this path. I suggest we continue with all possible speed.
Oh, boy.
Let's go. I think this is a really cool Zelda boss, by the way. Look who it is. Oh, it's you. Let me see. No, that's not it. This is so very embarrassing. But I seem to be at a loss for your name. Not that it matters, really. To tell you the truth, I'm feeling a bit frustrated, and right now, I just need someone to vent to. I heard my underlings had finally captured the Spirit Maiden, so of course I rushed over here. What can I say? Oh, I was excited, flustered even. But what did I find when I arrived? That agent of the goddess. She had once again. You see, what I'm trying to say is that goddess serving dog escaped with the girl! I must have the Spirit Maiden in order to resurrect my master. I must have her! I got a little carried away there, didn't I? I don't deal well with complications to plans I've laid out so carefully. It's a character flaw of mine. Ah, but something good can still come from this day. I've had all this bottled up anger smoldering inside me, and now I can release it. There's someone special I'd like you to meet. Oh, don't be shy. I need to vent all this unhealthy anger, and your agony is such a great stress reliever. It won't take more than a few moments with my friend before you're charred to a satisfying crisp. And let me tell you, that will put a spring in my step. Get down here and catch these Joy-Cons, buddy. Uh, Uh-oh. Oh, right, yeah, I remember this, yeah. Pyroclastic flow, I mean fiend. Scaldera! I think I just straight up go bowling with him. I think he blows up the bombs, though, if I do this incorrectly. I think I, like, roll it into his mouth or something while he's... That's not what I meant to do. Like, right now. Oh, my Joy-Con. Like, right there. Oh, yeah, he eats it. That's what it is. All right, and then I... That's what it is. That's right. Sky, you think internally, spiritually, you're Rakdos, or is it? That's edgy. You think you're that much of an edgelord? Eat it. They do make it harder, that's for sure. Rakdos are people aligned with a circus. Sky, how does that make you feel? You live in a constant of not knowing what the fuck I'm doing. Oh, that was weird. Pushes glasses. Oh, fucking hell. Oh, right. That was dumb of me. I was trying to grab more bombs, but... Oh, wait. Fuck. Oh, god damn it. There we go. What the fuck? Oh. Oh. Hey, what's up, Anna? You like this dungeon? Bombs. You're in your new job, you don't know what you're doing by definition. I bet you're doing a great job with it so far, honestly. Hey, what's up, Pat? Yo, good evening. How are you doing? Oh, God. Yeah, I thought that might happen to me. She's trying to help me, but I'm good. Roll at me. There we go. Let's go! Woo! But how's it going, Pat? How you doing today? Welcome, welcome on in. And Ostavia, good to see you. GG's indeed. Do the rest of lab members say at the lab meeting Tuesday morning? Oh, our lab meetings are on Wednesdays. It's not horrible, but its weak is very little for it going compared to literally any other dungeon in the game. I will say I do really like the first dungeon, and I do like it more than this one. I think the atmosphere is kind of cool in this one, but I kind of wish we were fighting the dragon, not the boulder that became like a little spider thing. Because I felt like this was all build up to fight a dragon. I remember when I first played this, I was like, yeah, we're going to fight a giant fucking dragon. Ride its back, or maybe like roll boulders down its spine or something like that. I always thought that would be cool. GG's. Kind of apropos of nothing, but I love the icy Twilight Princess dungeon. Yeah, Spencer! The cabin where you're with the folks with pumpkin soup. I love that dungeon too. That one's really cool. Assuming that's the one you're talking about. Twilight Princess is such good dungeons, in my opinion. It's my favorite Zelda. I'm biased, obviously, but yeah, the Yeti couple. You've posted this already? Oh, have I played this already? I played the Wii one, but not the HD version. But the Wii one was like years ago. The tall ice knights, you gotta smash? Yeah! There's a couple ice puzzles there that I struggled with. Zelda, wait, it's me! Oh, she sees me. Incoming Zrake, a comment about him being ugly again. True! This sounds like a theme from Lord of the Rings. Do you know what I'm talking about? Does anyone know what theme I'm talking about? Maybe I'm making this up, but I swear to God, this sounds like a theme from Lord of the Rings. Which, have y'all been watching the TV series based on that world? Because I haven't yet, but I love everything Lord of the Rings, and I would definitely watch it. Master Sword, in the context of all video game swords, how much do you rate it out of 10? I think the lore behind the Master Sword is the coolest part about it, Spencer. I think the way that it looks is not super flashy and wild, which I'm actually cool with. But I think the story behind it is the coolest part to me. That's my favorite thing. Like the Excalibur-esque, you know, being the right person to pull the sword out thing. Like, I think that's really cool. And I like the circumstances of it. But I think it's okay. It's iconic. But I think objectively, I think it's okay. Do you have any favorites? Scarlet Sword Zelda is so pretty. I love her too. I think she's cute. I think all the Linnaeus stuff at this game is his peak. Oh, I think that stuff is cool too, actually, Anna. The TV series has been really good. You and Zelf have been keeping up. It's been good so far. How many episodes are there currently? Yeah, that across all Jen Smith kind of thing. Exactly. That's the thing I like about it. I love how consistently it's present and how just iconic it is in that way. And, you know, it's this thing of legend and the way you get it. Like, I think it's cool. But the design itself, I think, is okay. You cannot go to him, your grace. Remember what we discussed. Restrain yourself. Focus on the task at hand. I like that it's not the strongest sword usually, but it's a sort of ceiling. It has that very specific functional purpose, even if it's not the strongest thing in the world. Or the most powerful thing in the world. They come out on Fridays. 3 episodes. Got it. Are they hour-long episodes, or are they like... I would think so, right? I have to go. I'm sorry, Drew. I think it looks cool. Rings of Power or the Master Sword? I don't know. It's hard for me to describe my taste in, like, swords, because there's a part of me that... Oh, shit, okay. It took you far too long to get here. Looking at you, I fear the goddess is mistaken in her choice of agents. What do you mean? If this failure is any indication, you have no hope of defending her grace from those who seek to assail her. Brayblade is the true, even over Falchion. Yeah, Brayblade is great. Do my words anger you, boy? Do my words sting? Let them. If I had not come when I did, your Zelda would already have fallen into the hands of the enemy. The truth of it is you were late. You were late, and you failed to protect her. I send Zelda ahead to learn more of the fate in which she's destined to play a part. Oh, she's gonna roll on my keyboard. Oh, Zinnia, that... Honey. Honey. Rayblade is so cracked, except in Fates. Dude, I wanna... I'm excited to stream... a Fire Emblem game again at some point. The question is which one? Because I've never played... I've never played Path of Radiance or Radiant Dawn, shockingly. Even though it's, like, my favorite series. So one thought is to stream those. But also... I want to eventually play Thrasia, because that's, like, one of the hardest fucking ones. So, to me, it'd be cool to play 4 and then 5, Thrasia. So, it would be cool to do those two. But they're also long as hell, so I probably wouldn't do them back-to-back. If I had to choose a unique fire weapon, I think Rajinto... Yeah! You're a dirty dog, Wee, but I feel like Fate's just Hymen at best. That weapon is cool as hell. I'm a huge Fire Emblem 8 fan. I want Siegmund or Regenleaf. I think Regenleaf is so cool. Because it's like, it's a unique weapon that you get early that actually is pretty cool. It's not busted OP, but like it's pretty good. And it's unique and looks cool. And Ephraim is my favorite lord in all of Fire Emblem. So, yeah, the Druby one, that'll be our next Fire Emblem for sure. You like big flashy swords? What I was going to say is, I like flashy swords, but I also like... Even things like, well, now that we're talking about Lord of the Rings, I'm thinking about Aragorn, and even just, like, his relatively basic-looking sword that just has a cool-looking hilt. Like, I like weapons like that, too, frankly. Like, I think that's cool. Like, realistic in a way, but just with, like, fun details like that. They're really cool, Sirius. Do you, have you played any other Fire Emblem games? The two games being so hard to find on disc are one of the big reasons. It is hard to find them on disc. That's probably what I'll have to do, Sky, frankly. You have it, sorry, even if the unit management isn't the best. Druby Emblem, heck yeah, Brad! Also, my friend Bradfield, I hope you're doing well tonight. You can't honestly advise anyone to not seek alternate methods of playing the game. It's just too hard to get them. You liked Fates for its gameplay, graphics, music, and the artistic approach of the game. It seems like, too, in... Maybe it's just one or the other, I don't remember. But I feel like somebody told me, too, that... it's hard to find bad units. Like, there's good units, and you have a tough choice, like, in who you actually use, because you have a good cast of characters. Is that true? Dante's Sword Rebellion is cool. Ah, do you agree with that, Sky? Do you like Dante's Sword as well? I know you've seen it. You burn yourself out on Fates is probably why my memory isn't too fond. I wouldn't say there's a glaring issue. Fates gets a lot of hate. I still like it, even if it's, like, a little fanservice-y, and the story's not that great. Nero's Sword of Superior. All the characters are idiots. I will die on this hill. Listen well, chosen one. If you wish to be of help to her grace, you must summon a shred of courage and face the trials laid out before you. Only when you've conquered the trials will you be of use to Zelda. No sooner. Am I understood? You like Yamato? I haven't actually played Devil May Cry yet. Path of Radiance is easy enough that you can pretty much use whoever you want unless you're playing on the Japanese-only Maniac difficulty. Hey, Modern DC, good to see you. I'm having a great night. How's your night been? Are we sad now? Are we angry? We weren't here fast enough? We were almost here fast enough. I did leave for like a week, so I guess waiting a week to play this game took us too long. DMC Val will make you have a lot of pleasure. Okay. Huh. I will say, that view of him is not the most flattering, Sureka. I'll give you that, okay? Master, I have a message written in the language of the gods of old. Allow me to translate for you. Red Queen's cool too, but I'm a Dauntless shrimp. What can I say? Hey, what can you say, Zelf? Honestly, fair. Your night is good, you're just chilling. You moved to Boulder a few weeks ago for grad school? Dude, what? That's awesome. You're going to CU Boulder? That's awesome. Good for you for getting in, frankly. I guess I don't know. I don't remember what program. You might have told me before that you're in. But Boulder has a really good biochem program, and I did not get into Boulder. Fun fact. I think there's multiple reasons for that, but I didn't get into Boulder when I applied. The spirit maiden who descended from the clouds has passed through the earth spring and made her way to a faded place. She's singing, but I'm not about to sing in her voice. You want to explore it's about character? I mean, this is a joke, though. I mean, if it's too big of a spoiler about this game, I'd rather not. Only because of the people who are here who maybe haven't seen this yet. Depends on the spoiler, I suppose. Also, what's up, Squidgy? How you doing? By useless... Oh, yeah, you said Radiant Dawn has a bunch of useless characters. Unless you dump a ton of resources. Got it. That sounds rough, Sigma. And, like, on easier difficulties, too. So you Boulder studying computational linguistics, no biochemistry, biochemistry is more competitive. I bet yours is competitive, too. Good for you, though. I hope you like being there. Boulder's expensive to live in. But it's a cool place. I go there actually fairly often to hang out with friends there. I like Boulder. It's about Impa. If it's what you're thinking about, I think you could, I don't know. I shouldn't let you say it. Do you want to DM it to me, actually? Do you mind? Because then I guess I could say if I want to say it or not. But either way, I would appreciate seeing, because I do know some spoilers about Impa. So I mean, my monkey brain just revs my sword and releases happy chemicals. The sword that turns into a motorcycle. God. Also, Anna, we're going to Lineru soon. The parched desert of Lineru, that is where the Chosen will pass through the gate of time into a distant world. Yeah, she's just spin and spin. I hope she's not dizzy from how long I'm letting her go. The moon is going to crash into Terminal! Oh, true that, Squeaky. There you go, Scythe, that's her. People spin spin. And there's our next little map. Our next tablet. Oh, that, yeah, that's fine. I can get you that. Alternatively, what I was going to suggest is you can send me a DM on Twitch. But I can hook you up there, too. Give me a sec. Invite copy. There you go. We got the amber tablet. Let's go. All right. How about this? We were talking about cool swords. We're also kind of on the topic of Fire Emblem. Here's my question for you. In the Fire Emblem weapon triangle, there are swords, axes, and lances. What is your favorite among the three? Or, if it's none of them, you could say bows, I guess. I mean, bows aren't... They're sort of separate to it. But we'll say out of those, what's your favorite slash what would you be as a unit in Fire Emblem? Axes, Frederick? Good answer. That's a good answer. Dante, Rakdos, Nero, is it? Virgil, Demir. That's their houses. Hello, little bokoblin. Oh my god. I'm playing this like a buffoon. Yeah, magic's fine too, if you want to say that. I guess that just opens up a lot of different kinds of magic too. Sword sprint, you already know. Damn, y'all are in sync with that. By the way, we will come back and do this at some point. Play this minigame more. I'm gonna actually go up to the surface, I think. I need to unlock the next area, but also I have things I wanna do. I should save too while we're here. I'll save and go to the sky, I think. I don't know where Anya is. You like acts too serious? You'd say probably a shaman, druid, etc. Wielding some dark magic. Now remind me, you start as a shaman where you only use dark magic, and then you become a druid where you use dark and heal, is that right? You don't also get anima, I don't think. I think you just get dark and heal. Unless I'm mistaken. Hi, Ani. What you doing? Yeah. What's up, Zeph? Yeah, we're talking about Fire Emblem. Yeah, you can just shoot me a message. I don't know. Yeah, go for it. There's like an anime accent saving chance. That's why I'm confused, because that's my favorite freaking Fire Emblem. Oh wait, oops. We should. Zinni's watching me like do this, and she's like, what's going on? Probably axes for physical weapons. My answer is lances. Lances are my favorite. Was it X? Oh yeah, there it is. I'm trying to remember what button you press to do this. Wow, we do have a bunch of these chests to go check out. Maybe we should go do that, actually. I'm gonna mark a couple of these. Can I do... Oh, I can only do one right now. We'll go do that next, I suppose. Swords, definitely. You think that the close second is you love Pegasus ladies? Me too! If I was allowed to be a PP bearing Pegasus knight, that'd be dope. Hell yeah, dude. I also love, I love, like, Wyvern Riders. So I also love, like, flying lance users, too. And yeah, those crit animations are super cool. My second choice would be, like, a Myrmidon slash Swordmaster, because I think their crits are also really cool. Shaman, Flux, Druid, Nosferatu, heal staves, and there's also the summoners. Yeah, we produce little goofies. In some games, they're really good. I never personally loved summoners, but they are good. Do I have to go higher? That's probably what it is. Lance, cool. Yeah, you Ephraim fanboy. It is me. I am a little bit of an Ephraim fanboy. But I do love a lot of other characters from that game too, frankly. Joshua, I mean, Myrmidon, right? Swordmaster. I love Joshua. It's ZL. I think I press... Or ZR. ZR. There we go. Okay. Lance Infantry are so flyers. Darkless staves are just funny because a lot of the strongest dark mages in the series are more valuable for the staff utility than their... Be nice to her. Oh, Zinni's grooming her now. Aww. Zinni is... Okay, Zinni's biting her neck now. Zinnia was licking Anya's arm. But then started biting her neck, so I was like, okay. Drop with that. A small seed satchel. Wow. Do I send an info of spoiler into Discord? Yeah, you can send me the spoiler by DM. That's fine. And then I can decide if I want to read it or not. Okay, the question was, who is the waifu? Who's the waifu? Okay. Let me think about... God, it's different from game to game. You like Flora? Katria? I like Katria too, actually. Okay, let me... God, I'm about to go through each Fire Emblem game. That's what's about to happen right now. All right, let's, God. Okay, FE1. Let me see if there's any FE1 characters. Who's gonna say Camilla? Someone's gonna say Camilla, obviously. Someone will say Camilla. I liked Sita because I liked her in Fire Emblem Heroes. But I think my answer from FE1 is probably... it might be Catria as well. I think it might be... It's probably either Catria or Sita, but probably Catria, I would say. Okay, so that's FE1. Let's go Fire Emblem 2. Fire Emblem 2... I do know that because of the remake. I mean, Celica's an obvious answer. Like, I like Celica, but do I have a different one? Or not Shadow Dragon. It's Echoes of Valencia. That's what it's called. Celica. I didn't really care for Faye very much. I don't know if I really have, like, one character in Effie. Sleek is cute. Sita's, like, the classic. Statistically, someone in the chat likes Camilla. True. Lissa is your favorite, Storm? Your favorite unit and warriors, choosing a tier list, the FE ladies. Yeah, your Grahatia cosplay mostly done. Oh, I gotta see it when it's done, Zeph. That's awesome. Someone's gonna cosplay Lina. Yeah, like the bunny. I would love to see a picture. Dorothea is the best. I do love Dorothea. She's a great answer from Ever Three Houses. You know, the dancer girls. You like the purple lady? Oh, well, there's a dude named Leon. Oh, Sonya. Wait. Is your answer Sonya? Is that who you're talking about? Hilda is S tier. Are you talking about Sonya? I think you are. If so, yeah. Yeah, I mean, yes. Yeah. Okay. Now, let's see. Fire Emblem... what's... I have to think. So I've never played 4. Was 3 the remake or the sequel to 1? I don't think I can do 3. Yeah, I was going to ask by game. I don't think... I've never played Mystery of the Emblem. I haven't played Genealogy of the Holy War or Thrastia. But if you have played those, let me know. Okay, FE6. Binding Blade Waifu Go. Oh yeah, I know. Is that Charlotte Storm? No, that's not her, is it? I mean, that might be... that might have been Fates, actually. That's not who it is. What's her name again? Shit. I don't remember. Okay. FE6. Fire Emblem 6. That's, you know, you got Roy, you've got... you know, Lilina or Liliana. I should put some respect on her name. I have played FE6. I'm getting so off topic, I apologize. By the way, I know a lot of people would say Deke. I know he's a dude, but Deke is like one of the most fucking loved characters I've seen in this fucking game. I think M'lady is like a good choice, I think, because she's a fucking badass. M'lady is so goddamn good. If you say Faye, I'm calling the FBI. Sophia's cute too. Spencer, do you have a thing for purple hair? Do you have a thing for purple hair? Just asking. Just ask it. Just out of curiosity. I think I would probably say maybe Cecilia. Guinevere can be a choice. M'lady. Cordelia. Oh, Cordelia's great too. Yeah. Sifei, you better be on because otherwise it's not gonna end well for you. Hilarious mode bonuses and this has hilarious base stats. Yeah, from M'lady. Yeah, she is such a good character. Yeah, I think Charlotte is from Fate series. I think you're right. She's literally the right answer. Okay, what about Blazing Blade? it's hard to not say Lynn. It's hard not to say Lynn, this, frankly. Lynn is like, I don't know. She's wonderful. I like Lynn a lot. I think someone said Florina earlier. And Sarah, too. She's also FE7, right? FE7 has really good characters. Dorothea, number one. Hector, fuck yeah, serious. Hector's my boy. Hector and Ephraim actually are my two favorite lords. I love Hector. I love Hector. I guess Ninian, too, frankly. I like Ninian also. Then this classic leg true. What's up, Ren? Hey, how's it going? Great to see you again. How you doing? I hope you're doing well. I think I remember you changed your name, right? I think you told me that last time you were here. Ephraim and Ike. Recurring lady at the weapon shop? Yes, Anna. I like Anna. Yeah, I think from that game, from FE7, I gotta go with probably Lynn. Ninian's up there for me too, but probably Lynn. Sarah is a funny character, and fucking Urk, who dragon is like dragged around. FE8, obviously. I mean, that's like my favorite Fire Emblem, and my. I don't know. I mean, I feel like Natasha was the first character that I liked, but Tana, Teth is. Drangirl's mid at best. Fingerk is suffering. FE8 is my favorite. It was my first one. It's not that hard of a game. You know, maybe some of the characters aren't as great. Ooh, maybe Oracle, or however you say her name. She's fun too. She's very like whimsical and. There's a lot of good characters in that game, in my opinion. Also, Selena. I know she's one of the antagonists, but Selena. She wasn't the Moonstone. What was hers? I'm trying to remember. She was great. I loved her. Laracle, thank you. Oh, what's your news? Florispar, thank you. Yeah. I loved her. That's my favorite. That's my favorite. Definitely mommy material. Okay, 9 and 10 I can't speak to because I haven't played it, but you're welcome to say it. 11 is Awakening, and I mean, I don't know. I feel like my best answer is probably... Or no, 11 is Shadow Dragon. I'm sorry. 11 is Shadow Dragon, and 12 is Awakening. Is that right? Or is I don't remember. Is 13... Wait, I gotta think about this. Because 9 and 10 is Path of Radiance, Radiant Dawn. 11 is the remake of the original. Like Cordelia Mar and Tharja. If you say Tharja, I will never sub again. I won't say Tharja. Okay, I won't say Tharja. I honestly think Cordelia's number one for me. I don't think there's any competition. Oh, Sumia's sweet. She's nice. I do like Sumia. I think Sumia's sweet, but I think Cordelia is just, for me, top tier personally. You have a little mini me running around in 8 to 9 months. Holy shit, congrats! Hey, that's awesome! Congratulations! Yeah, I agree, Storm. Sumida. what's her name? There's another red-haired like Pegasus girl in that game. Yeah, her, serious. Yeah. Cannot make me think otherwise. Base take. You said you wouldn't say Tharja, but I sure heard the name a lot now. Well, you did hear the name a lot. I mean, Tharja is like, God, she... Whew. I don't think I can handle that. I don't think I can handle that. There's some great characters in that game too. Also, I will eventually do a playthrough of Awakening for sure. So I just have the King of the Dance remap for one chapter. Crom Olivia. Olivia's great too. You're on vacation. Let's go, Gamer Pro. Ren, have you thought about... that's awesome, though. Are you overwhelmed or mostly excited? Or how are you feeling about it? Tiki's in that game too, right? I think she is. Okay, so 13 is Awakening. So that means 14 is Fates. And there's a lot of characters in 14. I thought Obero was cool. In Fates, I liked Obero. I mean, but let's be real. Kaguro just has some really just big things working towards her, you know what I mean? Olivia Crom makes a crackly scene in Inigo. Did you ever play Chapter Zero in Fates? I probably did. Sylvain? You do seem like a Sylvain guy. You and Skylar? God, Spencer, you two would get along so fucking well. You're definitely both Sylvain boys. Yeah. You have a friend who cosplays Tharis, which is 100% character on Robin, and she scares me. Yeah, that's fair. That's fair, Zeff, frankly. We're talking about Fates now. Kaguro Supremacy. Setsuna's cute too. She's nice. I like Setsuna. But I feel like probably Kaguro or Obero are my two favorites. I would say. The only kids I care about are the ones with Gale Force. Masada just sounds so rude for the best Fire Emblem archetype. Damn. I'm sorry, by the way, for anyone who's here who's like, hey, when is he going to play this fucking game again? I apologize, but you get me started talking about Fire Emblem, and I mean, I'm just... Sorry. In Fates, you say Hinoka. Oh, okay. She's, she's the short red-haired, from I almost said Hosidius. I've been playing too much Old School RuneScape. God, what is her kingdom called again? It's Nor and Hoshido, right? Yeah, don't apologize for that. I like Azura too. Azura, when I first played the game, she was my favorite. I married Azura first. You know, because the pink-haired healer? Hoshiden scum. The flyer, not the healer. Healer is Sakura. Yeah, that's right. Sakura, that's her. It's the younger one. Yeah, that's right. Look at this streamer talking about fictional waifus while I'm just here waiting for him to shut up so I can rescue mine. Sorry. Yeah, Hinoka's the short red hair flyer. Yeah. Takumi is the shithead brother. And then you've got, of course, Ryoma. Lobster boy. Weiss, that's kind of a base take.
My favorite Fates waifu was Soleil.
Yeah, I mean, I respect it. What was Tharja's, it's not Tharja. What was her name? What was the girl who daughter looked just like her, whatever it was? What was her name? Takumi is literally picking violence always, even one day in FE Hero, just being an asshole. Rashad, thank you! That's her. Thank you, Aishni. Not a wife, she's a precious daughter. That's fair. Cause Skylar is a... What was her dad again? Inigo? No, Laszlo. Gesundheit. You like Camilla? She grew into you? Oh, serious. We lost one. We lost one. Oh, I just saw the DM, by the way. Yeah, so I do know that spoiler, actually. Mmm. I'll have to notice that in that cutscene. I know exactly what you're talking about. Glad as justice, sinners repent. Mistrelay's hair is pink in Heroes. Takumi is the only character in the game with actual common sense. That's why you like him. What was the name of, there's the e-girl-esque one who's a cavalier. Like pink and blue ponytails. What was her name? I wasn't a fan personally. What was Perry, yep, there's her. The sport girl. Oh man. Perry got benched immediately. Me too. I benched her immediately. Okay, let's see. What do we basically just have three houses left, right? I'm with Sprint. Dorothea, but also Hilda. 100%. Dorothea, Hilda. I mean, those are my two favorites. Shark, if he wasn't on a plane to Europe or to England right now, would be saying Edelgard. Alright, I think we got through it all. That was a lot. That was a lot. What about husbandos, though? We just go right back into it. Okay, that one we can't get yet. Shark is an Edelgard worshiper. Mercedes. Mercedes is sweet. I hated her, well, time skip, frankly. I wasn't about it. Bernie, Bernadetta. She's a sweetheart. She's nice. And relatable for a lot of people, too. I guess we're on F-minus tier, so poor written that just makes the characters around her worst. Hilda! Shamir? Hell yeah! That's a good answer, too. Thank you, Sirius. Thank you. I haven't played Three Hopes yet, but I think her appearances look... I think I liked her character portrait in that game. From what I saw. Who's gonna say the teacher? Or what's her fucking name? Oh god, what's her name? Oh, I love Happy too! I also like Happy from Ashen Wolves. What's her name? The fucking teacher who, like, is kind of a mess. Has some troubles in her dating life, thinks she's gonna be alone forever. Someone's gonna say her, right? Manuela. That's... Where are the Manuela fans at? I'm waiting. You don't see the appeal for Edelgard, Brad? Byleth or Guileth? Dude, Sirius, you have such good takes. Man, I love all of... Great choices. Great choices. Obviously, that's not every game, but that's a sampling from some of them. I completely agree with you. You can get Shamir in every route without much effort. She can get into sniper way before everyone else. Hunters volley everything to death. She doesn't need anything to get going with. Not to love about her. I like this area, by the way.
Yo.
Whoa, is that you, Drew? Never thought I'd run into you here. What is this place? Yes, here's my secret spot where I come to work the kinks out of my sword arm. There was a time I was the most popular guy in all of Skyloft. Folks were always cheering me on like it was a parade. But as you know, time passes. And I'm not the young buck I used to be. I eat when I get stressed, and I'm worried about my darling daughter all the time. I haven't played FE4, but Sigurd was my favorite character that I used in Heroes. I mean, look at this belly! That's what drives a fella here to chop some bamboo. Let me tell you, there's no better way to sweat off those pounds. Here's an idea, Drew. Why don't you try slicing some bamboo? Sure. I think I'll like him too. Felix, Raphael, Dimitri. Raphael grew on me so much. Raphael grew on me so much, Sprint, when I played Golden Deer. I didn't appreciate him until then. I did every other route. I did Golden Deer last, and then I liked him. Get 100 cuts without dropping. I'll give 5 subs when I have the cash. I'm broke right now, but I'll owe you then. Oh, if you're broke right now, dude, you don't owe me anything, but I'll do my best. My mom's a glorious hot mess. I like your character a lot more than I thought I would go into 3 houses. Claude's personality, I like Claude too. Lilith's implants canon. Also, what's up, Scythe? Marianne, she's a sweetheart. Marianne's very nice. That's a spirit chop away, boy. Hope it's saying, get your horses holded. There's gotta be a way to spice things up a notch or 3. Oh, that's the ticket right there. You're gonna take a swing at whittling down that big old bamboo right there in the middle of the room. The thing you see is a contest to see how many cuts you can make before it hits the ground. If you're good enough, you'll straw out of here with the prize. Let's go. I don't remember the best way to do this. Oh, dear fucking god. Well, shit. I have to sleep. Sorry for ruining the stream. I mentioned wife. It was my very much enjoy myself. I enjoyed it too, man. I enjoyed it. No, I appreciate it. I love talking about Fire Emblem. So you're all good, man. Oh, with a longer blade. I'll do it again. We're talking about Bernie's Ted tree. Oh, I remember hers. How the fuck do you get 100? I don't think I ever did that. Let me get 15. Maybe I can go slightly faster than that. Diagonally too. Ash is an interesting one for me, Sigma. What's my prize? A golden skull! I'll do one more. Until I stop getting better scores. Let's try diagonal. Okay. Just do this! That was bad. That was fucking bad. Okay. But I tried. And a monster horn? Oh, heck yeah. One more. That was worse. Okay, I'm done. Get tired of all the tier list shit talking to hit the gym during the time skip. Yeah, people don't tend to rate Ash very highly on those. You're done? No, you're Drew! I said a dad joke to Chris earlier today. He said, hello, I'm full of sushi. I said, hi, full of sushi, I'm dad.
Yeah.
Thanks, Dad. Hey, Asia. Hey, done. I'm Asia. What's up, Master Asia? Got him! That was in Zelfstream. A silver rupee! We're rich! Holy guacamole. Oh yeah, we need to be able to swim underwater there. Alright, let's go. Oh right, there was still an item there, actually. I need to go back there. Brad. Not impressed? Maybe not. How's your Marine Base? I'm great! I had a really fun weekend. I kind of wish I didn't have to go back to work tomorrow because I've been busy all weekend, but it is what it is. Hey, not back there. Out. They're like rolling on top of each other back behind all my fucking consoles. Which they're better organized now, but they'll definitely unplug something. Oh shit. Is it on top? I don't know where it is. It's on the back of this. Oh, ta-da. ₹300? Oh, shit. I hope that doesn't cap me out. We're not capped. Okay, maybe I will go back to Skyloft next, just because I'm a little afraid about if that's another thing of rupees. I don't want to... miss out on a bunch of rupees from that. So let's go spend some. We got a lot of money to spend. I think my wallet, I don't remember how much it holds, but I think we're getting close to the limit currently. Dragon, no, hit me with it. Who did you sacrifice in the prologue of FE1? Sacrifice this! I need to check. I do not remember. Give me a sec. What's up, Takato? How are you doing? That's one king, that's 13 XP. That's a very good question because it popped up here in Colorado, so. Okay, how loud is this? Is this. It's fine. Get a Mabel. Customize? I didn't. Yeah, I played the original that was ported to the Switch. What is she wielding? Oh, you got to choose in the original? What does she have? She has an iron sword? Oh, I should get her a lance then. Shit. Alright, there we go. Let's pick up, because apparently we have a fuck ton of money. I'm great, I had a really good day today. Get you, and Drog, it's like a cross. Magic. I think homie's got a... Not in every game. Is she also... Wait, I feel like an idiot.
the call. The time has come.
Maybe I didn't do the prologue.
I just need a hit that will kill. So hopefully this does at least two damage.
Oh, maybe I never did that. Lucien takes me back? I know. I miss him. Consult the Jedi Archives. Got it. So I guess I don't know, because I did play the original. Let's go buy some stuff. Definitely take the upgrades. Small bomb bag! Thank you. My pouch is full! Oh. Watchy is weird. I'm sorry. Yeah. Oh, right, it is full. I see. So I definitely don't need both of these satchels. I definitely would pick up a bigger bomb bag, though. I think I understand this. So basically, you can just buy as many of these as you want and have as many of them as you'd like. I'm gonna not buy more stuff currently. Let's see if I can upgrade anything cool now. If I have the materials. Have you ever thought, oh my god, what an awful voice I have when you list yourself? I used to. When I was when I was starting the stream, I was incredibly self-conscious about my voice. So I always felt like it was too high-pitched. Like, growing up, I was self-conscious of it, and then streaming, I was self-conscious initially, but I've come to not really feel that way. I need another monster claw. Monster claw. Alright, well, none of this shit, apparently. Sorry, Gondo. Same for you being weirded out by your own voice. Some people are like, ooh, love the sound of my own voice, and are a little narcissistic about it. I've never liked the sound of my... Well, I don't know. I'm okay with it now. It's not like I love the sound of my voice, but it's me. I don't have any other voice but my own, and I just am accustomed to it, so... Come here, Beetle. When I was a young warthog. There we go. I love this Beetle in this game, by the way. I love me some me. That's fair, Sigma. I did in high school, but I didn't like singing very much. This is what I want. An extra spot! 600 rupees? You're raising the price, fucker! Yeah, he does actually raise the price. Or no, you made that up, Storm, didn't you? I guess he just was selling the next one for more money. Ba-ba-ba-bum! Thank you! Inflation, bitch. Make him go angry. Yeah, he'll drop me, right? I don't remember how you do it. Doesn't he drop you? Depending on what you do? I don't remember how you do it, though. Imagine being gaslit by Beetle, right? Oh, he just drops you, don't buy anything. Okay, so let me just go back up and then just stand there, I guess. Remember being weirded out not too long ago by someone who sounded absolutely obsessed with themselves? It's just like a weird, I don't know. Like, I'm not saying everyone has to dislike the sound of their own voice or dislike aspects about themselves. It just is a little off-putting when people are just, like, so full of themselves. Be confident, not... Why are you on a bicycle? I don't want to buy anything. Drew, would you please show the crowd what happens if you look at the goods and don't buy anything?
Oh.
An adventure pouch? 1,200 rupees? No, thank you. This?
Oh.
A life medal? No, thank you.
Oh!
Nothing for sale there.
Oh!
Oh! No, thank you.
Oh!
Tremendous set stuff. Do I walk out? I don't remember what I'm supposed to do here. Yeah, like just talking about it constantly, Brad? That makes sense. You did? Kododon! Dude, that's awesome. I loved Final Fantasy Tactics. That game was amazing. My weekend was great. I had a buddy who visited me. And we had a really good time together. Oh, here it is. Oh, please wait a moment. Do not have your RF peg a little extra hard with you up here. And you have the golly without buying anything off with you. The little smile. There it is. He said, get out of my thing. You know, I did just buy a pouch from you, so I feel like that's a little unfair. But that's okay. Now I do have space to fit a couple more things. I think I'll just go with these for now. I love Beetle from this game too! Alright, I'm gonna go check out that other... Well, I guess while I'm here, I could go get the tablet. But then I do want to go get that other chest that I missed. Maybe we go deliver some pumpkin soup too. One little thing of pumpkin soup. You're dumb that I'm so dumb now, and I was also dumb before. Never beaten a Final Fantasy game? You will. Yeah, Sprint's the Final Fantasy expert. Hey, that I took that in Breath of the Wild. Such an iconic part of his character. Oh, randos with FF Tactics? I think that'd be hard. Tactics was a legitimately difficult game. Especially initially, until you figured out how the fuck it worked. I don't think I have to do this, I just have to put it in. If y'all are fighting like this, love me some spice. Oh, shit. I think that'd be cool. Hard, though. Hey, there it is. You got it. I've confirmed the location of a third opening in the cloud barrier in the sky to the southwest. New area. Let's go. Yeah, I'm out of the other beans. I gotta buy more. I keep forgetting to do it. But I should. Your other favorite shopkeeper is the one from Dinosaur Planet Star Fox Adventures, particularly when he gets mad at you for haggling him until you get out of a store. I have still never played a Star Fox game, but I need to. Alright, cheers. I haven't had one of these in a while, actually. It's been a few streams since I've been forced to eat one. Jalapeno! You remember how you were fooled thinking the Lanayru region was supposed to be a water region and it turns out to be a desert? Yeah! It was a little bit surprising to me. I didn't like it at first, but I grew to enjoy it eventually. Cheers! Yes, cheers. I hope you enjoy Tactics. It truly is fantastic. Jalapeno! Jalapeno. Mmm. I don't know, Takato. Sorry. Yeah, I know. Serious to you. I know you said you're Mexican, right? So I'm sure my pronunciations make you cringe a little bit. Eventually, I'll start getting into some of the side quests this game. But not for now. Sprint, I love tactical RPGs. I haven't played that many of them, but I do love them. The only thing about Spanish that I've really retained from learning it for a few years in high school, it's really good about keeping vowel sounds consistent. That's like the biggest thing I took away was if you know your A-E-I-O-U, El burro sabe más que tú. And then you just think about pronouncing your vowels using those sounds, you generally speaking can sound like you're pronouncing words okay. Yeah. Vocals, yeah, vowels. Yeah, the vowels do sound the same from what I've been told. But as you watch Gargoyles growing up, and those who didn't, El no sabe, he doesn't know. El no sabe. Alright, Drew, you have either the ability to teleport to anywhere you've been before or fly, which you take. Teleport. That's just too convenient. Flying would be fun. But I feel like flying would be fun, but teleporting is too damn convenient. Hey, hey, hey! Fucking cats! I swear! Sorry, where was I going? Oh shit. There we go. You ready? What? Oh, the Pokemon Ho-Oh. Yeah. That is one of my favorite Pokemon legendaries. Because Gen 2 is my favorite. It's my favorite generation of Pokemon. Rupee? Ah. No sabe. I loved Lugia and Ho-Oh. Those were definitely favorites of mine. I did prefer Lugia over Ho-Oh because I was more of a silver boy. But I did Crystal was my absolute favorite. Crystal is arguably my favorite Pokemon game, period. I think Heart Gold, Soul Silver are really good remakes, by the way. Chocobo Zapdos from the new games. Chocobo Zapdos! Something came in the mail. Oh, what was it, Sprint? You got the treasure medal. If you carry this with you, treasure will appear more often. Everything take longer to treasure hunt. That's cool. Hell yeah. That'll stay here. That's great. Any favorite legendary? Ooh. Mercury, let me think. Favorite legendary. I mean, I'm such a Gen 2 fan. I think the dogs are cool, too. I remember being a kid and thinking, like, you walk around in the grass and the music changes. And you randomly find Entei or Suicune there in the grass. And you're like, holy shit. This thing could fuck me up if it tried. I was really blown away by Gen 2 shinies, or Gen 2 legendaries, I'm sorry. All of them were, I loved all of them. I think, God, I'm about to say all of them. I'm about to answer your question with every legendary. I think Gen 1 legendaries are cool. I loved the naming. I thought Articuno, Zapdos, Moltres. I thought that was cool. You know, 1, 2, 3, just cool. I liked it. Mewtwo's pretty iconic, but maybe not personally my favorite. Gen 2, I love them all. Gen 3, Kyogre and Groudon were really cool, because I just love the way that they were interconnected in the story. Poyo Quattro? That's my favorite. I think the Groudon-Kyogre and, like, rivalry in the way it was in the story was really good, so I liked that. You love Gen 5? Gen 5 I didn't like initially, but then I played it again on stream and I came to realize I was not appreciating it. Which of the legendary bird Pokemon in Gold and Silver was your favorite? Probably Lugia. Yeah. This came in the mail. Pants grab. Okay, let's see. Yeah. Gen 4. Or I guess we haven't talked about, like, Latios and Latias yet. Damn, you got Pokemon Yellow, Silver, and Crystal in the mail? Dude, that's so cool! Can I show it? Do you care? Do you mind if I show it on screen? Rayquaza because you shiny hunted it? And that's a cool shiny, too, frankly. Wild Roaming I thought was really cool and scary, too. Mega Mandos. Let's see. What were the Gen 4 shinies? That was the, that was Palkia and Dialga. And then Giratina. Giratina was wild. Because I just did a Nuzlocke of Platinum recently. And dang, when you meet Giratina and the area that they're in, holy shit. I remember that just like blowing me away too, frankly. Look, this is the picture Sprint just sent me. You got the lime green Game Boy Color. I had the like the dark purple one for Game Boy Color. My advances, they were both dark purple. Yeah. Darkrai is neat. Super cool. Thanks for showing me, Sprint. That's super cool. Sent from home. It's a fun package to get. Super Pog. Oh, let's see. What else were legendaries in Gen 4? Oh, you know what we haven't talked about yet? Did y'all like the Regis? If your answer is no, that's fine. But I want to know what you think of the Regis. I, too, liked their concept. Concept of Darkrai haunting a city and putting people to eternal sleep was cool. Oh, shit. Fuck. Mega Man Dust! You'll be submitting that message to EQS17. Dude, let's go! Oh, I will absolutely watch you do that. Oh my god. The way you're supposed to get them is kind of bullshit. I had one of those guides, the books, and I was like, this is so cool. You have to use the code in Braille and bring a fucking Relicanth over here or a Wailord to get in here. Wow, that's so cool. But now it's like, god, it's kind of a pain in the ass. Regigear. Regigigas, Regigear. Give me Metal Gear Solid, but Rex is Regigigas. Okay, let's see. Gen 5 was Zekrom and Regis. No. Shit. Zekrom and. You can tell which one I had. Reshiram and Reshiram and Zekrom, right? Yeah, you can't feel the Braille on your GBA screen, right? The noises are cool. Yeah, I thought they were cool. I'm gonna be honest, I don't remember many of the legendaries after that. X and Y, you've got Xerneas and Yiv. Oh yeah, Kyurem. Yep, or Kyurem. Kyurem. Yep. I don't know if I. I think I got Kyurem, but I did it like once, and I didn't do it during my most recent playthrough, so I don't remember it that well, frankly. Yivit something. I don't remember. I thought that concept was cool too, Sirius. Reminder that Regigigas sounds like this in the anime. Let's listen. I also never played Black 2, White 2, by the way. Let's listen. Does Regigigas sound like that? What? Is it one of the best games in the series? Maybe I'll Nuzlocke it. Maybe I Nuzlocke that before I Nuzlocke X or Y, because that would be my next in the series. I mean, like, black 2 and white 2, maybe, I don't know. X and Y would be next by Jen. All of them sound like that. Regigigas.exe has stopped responding. That'd been cool if their shinies were the opposite colors like that. Yeah, I would love to watch a Solok with you two again. Deliver the Dreamy Nuzlocke, then I usually die. As do most, frankly. Most do die in the Dreamy Nuzlocke, unfortunately. It just happens. And here we are in Linmeiru. Report, Master Drew. We have arrived at Linmeiru Mine. You got him Scarlet? Oh, that'll be fun. It's your favorite area of the game? Yeah, see, I think this is a popular one. I think the time mechanic is really cool. I personally really enjoyed it. I felt like I was an idiot the first time I played this. I didn't understand how to do things right, so I didn't like it as much. But I came to really enjoy it. I have seen the cover Legendary Storm. That I have seen. My projections show that Zelda must have traveled through this area. Thank you. I guess I'm supposed to douse for her, but like, why? What is the point for dousing her, for her, when I know that she's at the end of the fucking area? Wow, she's that way. Cool. Who would have fucking thought? Sorry. That's like, maybe that's a dumb gripe for me to have, but it's like, do I really need to constantly use the douse to find her? It's pretty linear. Using it to find, like, hidden, you know, kukris, whatever, that's fine. That's helpful. Got it. Imagine the egg on your face if Zelda was like behind the start. Fair. I thought she was towards the back of the tower where there's nothing. I am so surprised. The little robot. My estimates indicate that this object has been broken for many years. I am unable to analyze the content of its speech at this time. Oh god, it hit. Whoops. Who would have thought? Okay, if on the topic of doing Pokemon Nuzlocke, which game would you rather see first? Would you rather see... Would you rather see X or Y? I don't know which one I'll do yet. X or Y. Black 2, White 2. Or, like, Scarlet Violet. I wasn't planning on streaming that right away. I generally don't with new games. But if I do end up doing a Nuzlocke, which one would you want to see out of those? I've already done Gens 1 through 5. I would definitely come back to those at some point, but I'd rather try new ones before I go back to them. I think I'm supposed to hookshot up there? Yeah. They could be invisible at the end of a hallway and view would still make you douse, right? Oh, is there a poll up for that question? That's fine too. Would you rather see Drew play XY? Black 2, White 2, Scarlet Violet. There you go. Poll is up. I'll ask when I'm actually closer to playing it too, but I am curious what you think. Do y'all have a favorite starter from Scarlet Violet so far? I think I know what Chris's is. I also think I know what Haru's is, too. Based on emotes alone. The batteries on your Wiimote are running low. No, that's not gonna cut it. Fuecoco! Yes. I was thinking of his emote. Start going in the box immediately. Damn. There it is, Haru. Yeah, so I knew their favorites. Can I pull it? I think I can. Yeah. What about the cat? Anyone like the little kitty? You're getting Quaxie naming it. I almost read that as Yusuke because I just watched Yu Hakusho. Josuke? Is that a JoJo reference? I'm not trying to say the fucking meme, but I actually haven't seen JoJo yet, but I will.
Yusuke! Yurameshi!
I love Quaxie's hairstyle. It is a JoJo. Oh no, roll it. Oh, Kuwabara. If he's who I'm thinking of, I can imagine why. Yeah, let me look him up. Yep, yeah, it's that guy. Yeah, it makes sense. It makes a lot of sense. Hair, same hairstyle, just black hair. All right, we're full now. Do I have to bomb something here? He said the meme? Brad. You cracked me up, Brad. Now... let's just go to the middle here first. And watch this! I thought this part was so cool. If you can make $40 an hour picking bomb flowers, but had to risk them potentially blowing up if you handled it correctly, would you take the job? What kind of injury are we talking about from blowing up on me?
Where did you come from? We're here collecting time shift stones and transporting them to the Nehru mining facility. Stay away from the blue stones. They're too dangerous for humans.
I am able to confirm that a time shift has occurred since the space. Am I dying? Is it risk of death for $40 an hour? I can do better than that. Give me more money than that. Damn, wait. Do we know what the evolutions will look like? I love that. I love that image sprint. Any impact to the blue stones creates a sustained temporal disruption in the surrounding area. Readings show that this area is in a past time state. Yeah, I know those aren't confirmed that you just sent me, but are there any that are confirmed? It covers dental too? Alright, deal. You got an ancient flower! What day does that come out again? It's like or November something, right? Comes out in November. Realistically speaking, would I be playing a new game of that month? Maybe. November 18th. Whee! I remember feeling like an idiot that I couldn't figure out this mechanic very well. I do like it. I hope they keep it that way. Pokemon games seem more fun when you don't know anything going in. So now, this one, I think I throw a bomb in, don't I? Here you go. We're playing basketball. It comes out Augmentmotuary 30 seconds. Have a linear mining facility, thank you. I like this part of the game. When's the Splatoon 1 stream? I don't know, I got so many games to play. So little time. Zinni. Bomb flower handling might be for an hour, but I gotta wonder if the damage model will be the same. The scheduled date of my dissertation. You got that right. Oop. Just buy some time. If you could purchase more hours of the day, how expensive do you think that would be? Also, I feel like that would be a shitty world, if I'm being honest, where you could buy more hours of the day. Like, imagine all the shit that rich people would do to get to live longer. Or, like, be around longer. Pokemon Rooster. Zinnia, honey. Oh, you're cutting up my arm nice and good, Zinni. Nice cut you just gave me. They thought people were gonna leak them anyway. Maybe we should reveal them ourselves. Imagine real life being more paid when it already is. Twice your salary. The Justin Timberlake movie? What was that movie called? I don't think I ever saw it, actually. Get out our bombs again. Oops. No, stop that. Your battery in your lifespan is running low. Drown. Sorry. Oops. Working is just trading time for money, then you trade that money for time. No, all those rupees I missed out on. Let's see. This is the way I came from. I don't think I'd blow this up, do I? To go further that way? Uh-oh. Oops. I don't think that does anything. Oops. Thank you for the stream, Gotta Snooze. Sleep well, Zelf! Have a great night, and thank you so much for hanging out with me tonight. I'm not that far behind, if I'm being honest. Oops. That's not what I meant to do. Did I just smack a bomb flower? Tumbleweed. Can I have it? You For 30% of your income permanently, you can freeze time, but you have to stay in the frozen time world for 48 hours each time you freeze it. Would you take it? Okay, wait. So are you saying each time I want to freeze it, I lose 30% of my income? How does that work? Oh, shit. What? Why was I sprinting? That was weird. So basically, you're saying I could get the ability to freeze time, but I have to deal with the boring shit of hanging around for 48 hours in this frozen time world. What you're also saying is that I have to pay some amount of money to be able to do this. Is it each time? Or is it like just a cost for having this ability? Okay, I lose a part of my income to get the ability. Freeze time, rob bank, wait for 47 hours. So you can do whatever you want for those 48 hours. It's just you have to keep it frozen for 48 hours each time you do it. So I can do stuff, I can interact with things, but... I need more bomb flowers. There's some. You do anything you want, assuming it doesn't require another object taking some sort of action. I think I would do that. I feel like you could make up for that lack of income with some stuff. Freezing time and having it be frozen for 48 hours would kind of suck, but I guess maybe you could sleep through some of that. And you can still control some things. Like, you could read a book or something, because you can, you know, turn the pages. You could go to the gym, you could read. Activate this one somewhere. Yeah, I thought that might happen. Can I roll it all the way through there? I might be able to do that. Oh, well, that worked. Can I breathe frozen oxygen? Actually, I could just do this. Ta-da! I meant to jump.
Skyward Sword, one of my faves. Hope you're
Oh, heck yeah! I'm having a great time. Ash Ketchum. 18. Did you change your username? You definitely did. Thank you so much for the 18 months. How's it going? I've been having such a great time playing this game. There we go. Sheesh. Oh. Hylian Andrew. Oh goodness, how have you been? Whoa, I like the name. Well, it makes sense. Why you love this game, of course. I know how much of a Zelda fan you are. Switch friend code. Yeah, here it is. Would you like a life hack for these dudes, please? Would you rather me call you Ash now? I'm happy to do that. Try thrusting? Okay. Oh, that's a bot, by the way. I was just telling my bot to send a... Okay, the motion controls are failing me here. They just dodge you. Oh my fucking god. You're all good, roommate. Totally great stories for us in IRL. Listen, I'm trying my best. Y'all are gonna have to listen to that sound unless I do something about it. The finesse. You're leaving for the night because I have to sleep before that. Is there a Discord here? There is! Yeah, let me get you a link, actually. Here you are. There you go. Sorry, let me catch up on chat really quick. What if the ability were activated by burping and then it freezes? 2 days in time quarantine if you accidentally burp? I think I would still do it, because, like, the worst thing that happens is I just get bored. Or I, you know. It seems like there's worse things, you know, that could be accidentally activated. That Time Stoppers movie where the dad aged faster from being stuck into the frozen time zone comes to mind. Then that one dude stopped time while stopping time and he could phase through stuff. The finesse. Things I want to see in Breath of the Wild 2. Filters in the map so I can look at like shrines. Like, yeah, repair mechanics, actual dodge roll. Yeah, so it is my code. So Andy the Robo is my bot. So I programmed it to spit out the code if I type in exclamation point FC. Hey, thanks so much, Sirius. I'm not far behind you. I kind of want to make it like a little bit further, and then I'll probably go to sleep myself. When's Battletoads a shit, Kona? Oh, I would play that. I would play Battletoads. Absolutely. But, damn, will that game tear me a new one. Ninja Gaiden was hard enough for me, I will say. Ninja Gaiden 1, 2, and 3. I needed save states for 3. Because the fucking continue system. We have arrived at Lanayru Desert. The terrain in this area changed dramatically as climate forces... Shit, sorry. I think it'd be cool, Rhett, right? Then you just... Ah, yeah, then you just can stay up for as long as you want, because you can sleep during that time. I have confirmed numerous areas of sink sand. Should you step in sink sand, you may be swallowed by the desert. As a safety measure, I recommend you check the terrain on your map with minus. Oh, let me see if I can get you another one then. This one should expire in 7 days. You should be good. Oh, that's the same link. That one should work. It should work. I'm not sure why it wasn't working for you. I don't know if anyone can make a different link for me, but... Thank you, Storm. Just nap or lunch breaks. I feel like you could really use that time. I might have the broken link glitch. Yeah, see if Storm's works. I just got a resub to Rimage. Okay, let's go a little bit further. I don't think I'm going to do this whole area tonight, this whole area, because it's going to take a while. But we can go a little bit further. They're all expired? Oh, man. Are you trying to do this on mobile, or are you doing it on... All right. Can I cut these? Up there, I suppose. Oh, if you can't reheat food, that might be tough. Come here, little homie. Shit. Did that work? I guess I could use the fairy now to spare you all the sound. I do love the hook shot. Or maybe it's called the claw shot in this game. I know that's what it's called in Twilight Princess. Thank you for the hydration, Kona. This is sparkling water, but I... Oh, shit, I'm out. Probably a couple of drops left. Let's see, which way do I want to go here? You got a tumbleweed! That is an item used for upgrades. Oh, I can catch some with the nets. I think I remember having to rescue little dudes in these. Oh, shit. Oops. Oh, you're good, Citrus. Maybe Storm can send it in. I was hearing some other noises that were making me concerned. If you eat the hot food before time is frozen, the baby is warm for 2 days. I appreciate you. If you out. I'm sorry, give me a sec.
Pretty sure Anya's messing with stuff on my computer.
Okay. Let's see. I don't know. I might just save this whole area for tomorrow. Or not tomorrow, for the next time we play. Because I think this part might... I don't know. I find it kind of daunting to do this right now, if I'm being real with you. Okay, here's what I might do. I'm going to go deliver a pumpkin. Some pumpkin soup. I'll do that once. And then I'm going to go to bed after that, I think. Because I get intimidated by this area. It's going to take me a while to get through it. So I think that might be what I'll do. That'll force me to use the fairy too, so I have a jar. Yeah, there's thought on stealth game suggestions, but it's back to Metal Gear Solid this time. Alright, hit me with it. I don't know if I can use it from here. Probably not. Yeah. Oh, there's one there that I got. That was the pumpkin spot. If you ever do portable ops, you have to play it on actual PSP or emulate. Do it after your break after Metal Gear Solid 3, but it'd be best to do before 4. It works! Let's go! There you go. I'm glad you got it to work. Sorry it was such a pain. It worked on incognito mode on Chrome. We'll get there when we get there. Do you agree with that, Chris? That timing? That I leave for tonight sounds good. You take care, Sirius. It's great having you here tonight. I hope that you sleep well. Oh, what? Well, I didn't go high. I wanted that too. Devil May Cry 3, but it's not considered canon anymore. A heart container due to someone IRL? Oh shit. I guess it has to be something permanent, right? Because heart containers do something permanent for Link. No, I can't even get into yet anyway. Clear their arteries? Just boost your heart health, yeah. Let's go down to the pumpkin landing. Portal Ops is a condensed version of the MSG3 engine. It does contain story elements calling back to Metal Gear Solid. I'm not sure what makes it not canon, because then you'd be spoilers. Your blood pressure, your actual heart would just be at peak health. Then what happens if you get another heart container? You have a bad knee for 5 years. Dang, a heart container would be nice right now. You want to implant it in your butt? Oh my goodness. Three hour containers, you've gone gear second. The lumpy pumpkin. Hello.
Oh, you're here just in time. Just in time for another job, that is. Your next job is to help pick the pumpkins. I don't want to hear any moaning or complaining.
Fine.
This should be an easy one for you. Kina spends her afternoons picking pumpkins in the patch out back. Carry those to the storage shed. Kina can give you the details. Oh, but you can only work on the patch during the day. There's no telling what will happen under the night sky.
Alright, Kina. I feel like there's like a ginormous pumpkin. I don't remember the full details, but I remember there being one. Hey, I see Sirius is in here. Do profile picture too. I like it. Hello. Oh, and your next job has been decided. Looks like you'd be helping with the pumpkin harvest. What a relief. Do you have any idea how heavy those pumpkins are? Oh, you think this is going to be a piece of pumpkin cake, do you? Let's make this interesting. How about you carry 5 pumpkins at once? You better take it slow or you'll risk dropping them. Just get out there and haul those pumpkins. All right. Mm. Down there, right? Walk slowly. Here we go. Aww. How am I supposed to lean here? I move. I don't lean. Why is this the way we're doing this? We could just carry the pumpkins one by one over. Oh shit, wrong way. Where I think of all these wasted pumpkins. Yay! Work harder, not smarter, Drew. This was slidey. She covered them in oil. Thank you very much. No problem. It's the American way. Work harder, not smarter. Sprint with those motherfuckers. Do, do, do.
Impressive! You've done harvesting all those pumpkins! Don't celebrate yet. You still got a ways to go before you paid off that fancy chandelier. Give me some time to think about what to need you to work on next.
Are you making some pumpkin spice? Who knows? Maybe. What is your favorite pumpkin-flavored treat? Do you have a favorite one? For me, for a long time, I would have said pumpkin pie. I love pumpkin pie. I feel like something like pumpkin bread is really good to me too. Yeah, Dylan. Pumpkin spice apple cookies? That sounds amazing. I'm gonna go back to Lineru and just save there. You know what? What's up, Storm? Maybe that's the point. The pumpkin thing is a trap. That sounds delicious, friend. That sounds amazing, frankly. It's an insurance scheme. That's what this all is. Alright, we'll come to this one. And we'll save here. You break him, you buy him. Oh, she just changed my lights. Indebted to him forever. By making me break those pumpkins. Your overtime didn't get entered for Saturday because the system and schedule ends at 11:59 Saturday, and you worked till 1 a.m. Sunday, so you didn't get to add that in! Oh no! What the heck, Brad? They give you for broken pumpkins and also charge you. It's just a scam! We're just increasing our debt even further. What the heck? I think a snake just attacked your camera. Yeah, a little cat attacked my camera. Actually, a little cat attacked my lights. Didn't choose India. Hey, sweetie. I'm just giving her a little belly rub. I'm gonna get your place. Oh, you saw her tail, actually. That's what it was. That's funny. There's always money in the pumpkin stand. God, I want to watch that now, Brad. It's a good reference. All right, everybody. Well, I think that's where we're going to call it for the night. I would love to play a little bit more. Ice Blue? Let's see. Now, the teal might make me look like a tomato, but we'll just try it out and see. Oh, Zinnia. Let's go with, like that color. We'll see how well this works, I suppose. Well, anyway, thank you, everybody. That's what I was trying to say. Anyway, thank you, everybody, for coming on in tonight. I hope you enjoyed the Skyward Sword. I certainly did. This game has been really fun. I've been loving it. And we did manage to do the Earth Temple tonight, which I thought was pretty good. And this area, this next one, before the mining facility, it's definitely a bit longer, I think. I mean, I suppose Elden's pretty long to get into it because you do have to, you know, find all the pieces of the key. You kind of have this, like, maze area you're going through. But I think this area is going to be fun. So I'm excited to jump back into this the next time we play it. Which, by the way, if you are curious, that is going to be on Saturday. So I have been playing Skyward Sword on the weekends. So Saturdays and Sundays. I didn't stream yesterday because I had some company around. But so I apologize for only one Skyward Sword storm. One Skyward Sword stream this week, but next week we'll be back with our regular schedule. We'll do it both days. And before then, though, I will be streaming on Tuesday and Thursday, and we are potentially finishing up Metal Gear Solid 2. I don't think we have that much left, so it seems like maybe it's possible that we beat the game this week. That's, of course, with me not really knowing truly because I haven't played through it before, but if I had to guess, I'd say it's possible. So that is the plan for Tuesday, Thursday. And then last but not least, on Friday, I'm kind of debating what to do because I actually might be learning the new Breath of the Wild Breath of the Wild Great Plateau percent speedrun. And if I do that, I don't know if I want to do that on stream. I don't know if I want to do that before stream. I don't know if I have time to learn it off stream. I might do a Metal Gear Solid speedrun, maybe. Or I'll do that. I don't know. But either way, probably one of those. And then multiplayer night is what I'm thinking. So if that sounds like fun, that'll be on Friday. I think that's about it. But didn't you hear it's the worst Zelda ever, Drewby? I know, it's such a bad game. I like this game a lot. I know some people don't like it, but I like this one. You have a good one too. Storm, Master Asia, Chris. I didn't get it, but I should have. I do have an account, actually. I might have messed up. Have a good one, Mr. Bratterfield. Take care. Thank you so much, Dylan Sprint. Have a great night, Sirius, if you're still listening somewhere out there. And anyone else who might be here hanging out or lurking or doing your thing, I very much appreciate it. And here's what I'm thinking. I've got a few friends who are alive tonight doing some different things. I feel like Final Fantasy X with Hannah would be really fun. I haven't played it yet, but eventually I will. And I know that's a popular Final Fantasy game. She's been live for a while, but I don't know how much longer she'll be live. That'd be cool, Brad. I would be down. I'd be very down. Yeah, Zinnia coming to say hey. Hey, Zinnia. What you doing, honey? She's coming to say hey. Yakuza 7 was only free for like last month, but there's still 0, 1, and 2. Sprint's a big FF10 fan. That I do know. Let's go say hi to her tonight. That sounds nice to me. I haven't played it yet, and I don't want to get spoiled on too much, but she's still pretty early on in the game. I think it's like night 3 or 4 or something like that. Drew, what's up, Brad? You trying to go back there again? Yes, she is. Hello, Sabe. Yeah, it's true. I don't know. Well, hi everybody. Hello. Blueberry, what's going on? Thank you for the raid. Kitty! Yeah, this is my cat. This is Zinnia. I have two cats. She's one of two. She's the older one. She's 2 years old. I just typed in slash raid. But I can't end quite yet now. That's kind of hilarious. But hey, welcome in. How's it going, everybody? Thank you so much for the raid. Scallydry, I hope I said that correctly. Hello, Jordan. How's it going? Agev, hello. Thank you for raiding Ghostbuster Kevin and Kenshin Cloud. Ethel. How's it going, everybody? Welcome, welcome. This is Wild. You're my recommended, and you're about to raid someone who I was also considering raiding. Well, hey, well, there you go. Okay, well then I guess I won't feel as badly if I keep it short and we just go raid Hannah. But hello, how's it going, everybody? It's great to meet you. For those who I haven't met yet, I'm Drew. I mostly stream retro, which I don't know if that's why I maybe popped up in your recommended. Tonight we weren't playing retro because I have been working through the newest Skyward Sword Zelda game. I generally play retro, but when it comes to franchises that I'm particularly fond of, I'll play them whether they're old or new. Right now we've been working on Skyward Sword. We're pretty early on in this game. Just finished up a dungeon tonight and onto a new area. During the weekdays, I've been playing Metal Gear Solid. Metal Gear Solid 2. So I don't know if any of y'all are fans of that franchise, but it has been my first time playing those games, and they've been amazing. So I played the first one. I'm right back into the second one. And I'm right back into the second one now, and it's been lovely. So that's what I'm doing on the weekdays currently, and it's been a lot of fun. But I see you're playing some Resident Evil tonight, which is pretty exciting. We were actually talking about Resident Evil 2 Remake earlier because our friend and moderator, Mr. Minokadobo, actually is speedrunning Resident Evil 2. You got some Metal Gear Solid fans in the community. You only finished 3, but you love that game. 3 sounds like it's a lot of people's favorites, and once I finish 2, I may go straight to 3, or I might do the OG Metal Gear games. I might try those out first, but yeah, I've got a lot of Metal Gear Solid folks around here too, who have been asking me to play the game for a long time, and I'm glad that I finally have gotten into it, because it's really been phenomenal. It's been a really great time, so... But thank you for dropping by. So I know you're obviously playing some Resident Evil. What else do you like to play? What else are you into? Because I would love to see if we have some other games in common. We were talking about Pokemon a lot earlier tonight. I feel like in terms of like mainstream franchises, I love Pokemon, Zelda, a lot of Nintendo things. I am a big Fire Emblem fan and like JRPGs, RPGs in general. So I've been working through like Final Fantasy games, I've been working through... I'm going to play Chrono Cross relatively soon, I think. I played Golden Sun, Legend of Dragoon. I also enjoy Metroid a lot, so I played a bunch of Metroid games. Castlevania. I played a bunch of Castlevania games recently. You love Pokemon? We play a lot of Pokemon. You have a couch full of plushies in your office? Oh, I love that. Okay. Have you seen the Scarlet and Violet spoilers yet? Because if you have, I want to know what your favorite is. Between the three. I want to know what your favorite starter is. And your favorite gen. Those are the two questions I'll ask you. Favorite gen and favorite starter from the new game. The Evos haven't leaked yet. The evolutions aren't out yet. But if you've seen the initial starters, I'm curious what your favorite is. It's hell. You suffer through horror games, and Sunday's a really good game, though. I've heard RE4 is a good place to get into it. I tried playing RE1. And I wasn't. I wasn't about it. Not quite my thing. I'm not great with scary games. What, was that not comfortable for you? Is that not comfortable enough? I'm coming out here. Oh, God, that clawed my leg. Golden Sun's so underrated. It's so good. I played 1 and 2, the GBA games. Eventually, I might play the third one. But I know that there's a big like cliffhanger, and the fourth one never got made. You love Sprigatito. You have a cat named Matcha, which is basically the same as a grass cat. I love that. Matcha, what is... All right, well, first off, I did go ahead and follow your stream because of other reasons, of course. But the fact that you have a cute cat named Matcha makes me want to go check it out. I'll try to come by sometime and come meet your cat. That's awesome. I have two of them. So, Zinni, you just saw. She was laying on my lap. Zinni just fell off my desk. I don't know how that happened. Here's the easiest way to get my cats to come out and say hi. All right, let me get her out really quick. Oh, there she is. I know, come on, little ones. Oop. Come on. Got little treats. I'll bring Ani up so y'all can say hi. Oh, she tried to get to my chair, but she didn't make it. I see. Let me get Ani up so she can say hi too.
Who's that?
Oh, this is my kitty Anya. She's just purring and chilling. She's kind of become a little bit of a chonker, but she's very sleepy right now, so she's being pretty sweet and chill. Zinni does have socks, yes. Zinnia's got the socks. Anya's got a little more white on her. And Anya is, she's about 8 months old now. 8, 9 months old. Zinni is about 2.5 years. I adopted this one in April, so I brought her home about 5 months ago. Zinni I adopted in October, so it's almost been a full year with her. Look at how tired she is. She can barely keep her eyes open. No, you're just a sleepy one, aren't you? She seems pretty content right now. Your cat hates being held, but he tolerates it. Really? So this one, she doesn't love being held as much. She's definitely more of a, especially when she's awake, you know, she's like, oh, you can say hi to me for a moment. I'll purr for a while as you pet me, but then I'll jump off and go run around the house and be wild. Zinnia is a lap cat. Zinni will lay on my lap for a longer period of time. Hi, sweetie. But yeah, she's sleepy now, so. How old is Matcha? Sorry, I'm just getting my... scrolling up on chat, seeing if I missed anything. Oh, by the way, I hope you're doing well, Shadowstorm, Storm Rider. I've been saying Storm Rider, but it's Storm Strider. I just realized that. I just realized that. I was going to go to bed here pretty soon because I do work in the morning. But I wanted to say hi, introduce you to my to my cats. I finally got... How long has it been that I've been messing up your name? It's been a long time, and I just realized it. Matcha is super affectionate, but only on his terms. He can rub his belly and everything, but he's intimidated 90% of the time. He's going to be 3 in a couple months? Aww. I think, like, I respect that, you know, cats with that personality. That's her, frankly. She's kind of like that, too. Unless she's tired, in which case she's like, yeah, sure, you can pull me or whatever. I'll just chill. And thank you for the follow, Xerxes. Sorry, I was working with Blue Braided, but I heard a few games here that I enjoy to play as well. Heck yeah, which ones in particular? I don't know if any of y'all are, like, Souls fans, but I have played all the Dark Souls games, Elden Ring, you know. I really enjoyed Sekiro, made by FromSoft as well. I'd say my favorites are, like, Fire Emblem, because I'm a huge, huge fan of Fire Emblem. I've played most Zeldas, but not all of them, so this is one that I had played the original, but I haven't played the HD one. And I feel like recently I've been really enjoying Castlevania, like, that Metroidvania style, or even the arcade style games too. I've been loving those. So I've been enjoying those for sure. Anya's Drew is interior decorator, aka destroyer of all things curtains. That's true. That is very, very true. Well, I think I should call it though. I had a long weekend. I had a buddy who was visiting me and we did a bunch of stuff together. And I think I should go get some sleep. But before I leave, first off, Blue, thank you so much for the raid. I don't know if you prefer Blue or Blueberry or what you prefer, but I'm looking forward to being by sometime. And I appreciate you coming in, sending your folks this way. I know, of course, we hadn't met. It's always a little bit like I hope this person's not this, that, or whatever. But so I appreciate you trusting to send some folks this way. We call her Blue because she's only 3 feet tall. 3 feet tall? Oh my goodness. I'm a little over double that. Heck yeah, Gen 2. Gen 2 is my favorite. That is my favorite gen. Your favorite series of all time is Final Fantasy. Favorite game is Vandal Hearts. And you love me some Pokemon. Favorite gen for Pokemon is 3rd, but I love Gen 2 reason the best. Yeah, Johto. I love Gen 2. Crystal's my favorite Pokemon. You're 4'11". Don't let her lie to you. She's 3 feet tall. So my mother is 5'3", and my dad is 6'3". So kind of a big height difference there. And then yeah, I'm on the dad side there. So, but you know, you look at streamers, you don't see their legs, and it's like, oh, you look at me and you don't really necessarily think that I'm, you know, I don't know. I feel like when I look at my torso or I look at myself on stream, I don't look like I'm that tall. So I definitely get people who like say, oh, I didn't think you were tall or whatnot. I'm sure that happens for people of all sorts of heights. Everyone looks tall to me. You know what? That's all right. Because if you ever need to kneecap somebody, you're in perfect position for that. You're preferring for a Skarmory Shiny Hunt is your favorite Burb Steel type and near my top fave Gen 2 fave. Skarmory is really cool. When I was a kid, I didn't appreciate Pokemon that didn't evolve enough, and I've come to change my mind on that. 69% legs. Definitely at least. Drew me 2 legs. She also just licks a lot, as you can see. Yeah, Zinni is, she's up on the curtain there. Never want to use Pokemon that didn't evolve, right? It's like, oh, they're not as good, because, you know, sure, they're maybe good initially, but the evolved ones gotta be better, right? That was definitely how I was. And, like, if you had 2 evolutions, oh, that's gotta be a good one. But yeah, Gen 2 is my favorite growing up. And then, yeah, I've done a couple Nuzlockes of sometimes randomized, sometimes not randomized. I was just actually talking earlier today about how I've never played Black 2 or White 2, so I might do one of those next, or I'm up to Gen 6, so X and Y. So I haven't decided yet. Maybe Scarlet Violet when they come out, but it's been a while since I've played a Pokemon game on stream, so that could be kind of cool. You just finished White 2. It's really great. Oh, okay. That's good to know. Because when I was a kid and I played Black and White, I was like, you know, these graphics are kind of weird. I don't really know how I feel about it. And then as an adult, I came back and I did a Nuzlocke, and I was like, this is actually a really great game. The story is fun. I liked N. I came to appreciate the art a little bit more. And then folks tonight have just been saying, you know, you really need to play Black 2, White 2, because there's just some of the best Pokemon games, period. So we could do that as a Nuzlocke. Aggron is your number one Pokemon. You love doing random Nuzlockes. You did a Heartgold run that ended at Jasmine, where her Steelix was returned into Rayquaza. Ugh. Randomized ones like that are so brutal. I did a randomized run of Yellow, and that's one of the hardest things I've done. My goodness. And it's always the early game for me, because end game, you expect them to have really good teams, but then if they're, you know, if Blue's Charizard turns into a Metapod, then it's like, okay, well, that's that's not so bad, right? But early on, if you're up against youngster Joey, who loves shorts and talking about his shorts, and then he comes out with, you know, something annoyingly powerful, then RIP. You didn't see Black White when they first released, but as an adult, I was like, damn, this game's fantastic. See, there you go. They're challenging too. Yeah, absolutely. You could play alongside of me? Heck yeah, Haru. One thing I wish was the clothing actually fit the models. Who at Game Freak is so adamant that ankles always be showing? When I do random Nuzlocke, I tell my average team level can't be higher than the gym leader's ace. That's definitely the another one of those restrictions that I think is a reasonable one to put on. Not by any means like required. When people play Pokemon games like that, I definitely don't want to like gatekeep how people to do it. But that is a kind of a fun sort of rule to put on. Hi, Zinni. What is it? You want to come up and say hi too? Yes, like I said, she's very much like a lap cat. She's going to come and be like, what's this fucking cat doing in my spot? Hi, Zinni. What you doing? Where's MGS? Tuesday. Tuesday, we'll play Metal Gear. That's what we're going to do. All right, Ani, it's time for us to end the stream and go to sleep. Although you probably won't sleep because you're nocturnal. As long as you don't keep me up all night while I try to sleep, then we will have no problems. I think the moment I move my chair, she's probably going to jump off, but that's okay. There we go. Okay. Well, everybody, I think that is time. I think I need to go end my stream. So I do still want to raid Hannah. And actually, that's perfect too, Blue. If you've not met Hannah before, but she was in your recommended... I followed Hannah for like, I've been following her for maybe like a yearish or so, but someone who loves retro, very, very friendly. She does a lot of like kind of first playthroughs like I do. And so we kind of have some cool overlap in that respect. It's fun because sometimes it's like, oh, I'm playing this game for my first time. And she's like, oh, I just finished playing it, or, you know, vice versa. She's currently playing Final Fantasy X, which I haven't played yet. I've played 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 Remake, Tactics, and I play FF14 pretty much every day. Oh, you have met her before! That's your favorite game of all time? Oh, snap! Okay, well, perfect, perfect. Well, if y'all would like to come on by and say hey to Hannah, I would definitely appreciate it, but definitely don't feel like you have to. You have an FF10 tattoo on your arm? Oh my god! Right now, what I've been debating, by the way, is what Final Fantasy game I play next, because... 8 is sort of, I mean, it's the next one in order, but I own 10, thanks to Sprint. I've heard it's a lot of people's favorites, and I don't necessarily mind skipping around because, of course, you don't have to play 9 to play 10 or play 2 to play 3 or so on. You know, they're all obviously independent in that sense, except for, you know, some exceptions. So, I don't know, maybe I play 10 next, we'll see. You play 14? I'm on Aether, Sargatannus. You're playing that today? Hell yeah! I've been playing the game for a couple years. I am fully maxed, but I don't really do a whole lot of like Savage Extreme stuff yet, but I love the game. I've been frankly doing the Island Sanctuary mostly recently, and working on relic weapons. So I've got all my ninja ones because I'm a ninja main. I'm working on a few other ones too, and it's been great. You're on Primal? Well, hey, good thing there's a data center transfer, right? I'd love to play with y'all sometime. Heck yeah, Xerxes, nice. Paladin's fun too. You play Chocobo Racing? Bum, 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 ba, da, 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 da. Oh shit, I gotta get you a non-raid message. Or a non-sub message. If you would like to come along, if you aren't subscribed, that's totally cool. feel free to take that. I know it's about to end in like 5 seconds, but thank you all for hanging out, and I will see you next time, all right? Y'all have a good time over with Hannah. Okay, I'll see you later. Mwah. Goodbye.